And you're good.
From this summer's Wolves football camp.
From Davenport High School Stadium in Garden Ridge, it's Friday night Texas high school football. Tonight, a week three non-district matchup between the Piper Warriors and the Davenport Wolves. Good evening and thank you for joining us. My name is Paul Alexander. I'm working alongside my partner, Joey Gonzalez. And Joey, through the first two games of the season, these two teams have followed really similar paths.
Yeah, both the Warriors and the Wolves have posted big wins in their respective openers, only to stumble a little bit last week. So they're both 1-1. Piper lost to Wimberley a week ago, while Davenport dropped a road game at Kerrville Tyvee. And interestingly, both the Warriors and the Wolves got shut out in the second half, so they're eager to get back to their respective offenses back on track.
Yeah, first down was a particular problem for the Warriors against Wimberley. Piper must stay on schedule and must stay ahead of the chains. We've got some good quarterbacks on the field tonight. The two Jakes, seniors Jake South and Jake Strachan, will split time for the Warriors, with South getting most of the snaps and Strachan moving to wide receiver. Davenport is quarterbacked by a left-hander, senior Tristan Hamlin, who threw 31 touchdown passes a year ago. But Joey, ball security will be a big issue tonight, especially for the Wolves.
Davenport turned the ball over six times in last week's loss to Tyvee. Hamlin threw two picks, and the Wolves also lost four fumbles. So you know that Warrior defense will go hunting for takeaways tonight. We'll also be hunting for some shade tonight. 101 degrees with a high of 104. 76 degrees will be the low, and a wind coming out from the southeast at 7 miles per hour.
Yeah, it's almost warm. Let's set our officiating crew for tonight. Headed by the referee, Ron Tatchy. The umpire is Mark Pennington. Grady Hatch is our head linesman tonight. The line judge is Chris White. The side judge, Chuck Marquardt. And Pete Peters is the field judge. We'll pause for our national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, this time, Miss Holly Bass will sing our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's anger, the bombs bursting in that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the brave and the home.
Anthem will set the captains tonight. First for the Warriors, number 7, Jake Strachan, number 8, Jake South, number 4, David Huntsman, a defensive lineman, and number 28, Landon Ashport, outstanding linebacker, but he had a knee braced up and appears to be injured. We'll follow that for you. Captains for the Wolves, number 1, Emmett Griman, their wonderful tight end, number 5, outstanding linebacker, Zahir Livingston, the quarterback, number 10, Tristan Hamlin, and at number 52, Ryan Howe. Piper is coached by Nick Rogers, while J.D. Zimmerhansel is the head coach at Davenport. The Wolves represent District 13 4A Division 1, while the Warriors compete in District 13 5A Division 2. And Joey, we mentioned the fact that both of these teams got shut out in the second half of their games last week. They've got to get off to a good start offensively just to kind of reinstill that confidence.
Yeah, and he can't turn the football over. I mean, it's really difficult to win football games whenever you have six turnovers in a ball game. So if Davenport can find a way to eliminate that, and then on the Piper side, you got to find a way to buy more time for quarterback Jake Strachan.
All right, we're just about set to go. Davenport won the toss, and they did not defer, as most teams do these days. They say, we want the football. And they'll get their wish. So they'll be moving left to right from north to south. And the Warriors set to kick it off. Daniel Miranda, number 81, will handle those duties. And deep receiving for Davenport, their excellent tight end, number one, Emmett Griman. A clear night, but a hot one. We're awaiting the whistle from the referee, Ron Tachi. And there it is. Here's Miranda. And with that, we are playing the great game. It's a good deep kickoff, going to result in a touchback. And the ball will come out to the 25-yard line. And we'll get our first look at this Davenport offense that was really prolific a year ago and lit it up in week one. And then fell off a little bit last week in the second half against Kerrville Tyvee. But they're really good, led by their senior quarterback, Tristan Hamlin. On the season, he has 8 touchdown passes against 2 interceptions. But he threw 31 TDs a year ago. And it'll be first and 10 from the 25 following the touchback on the opening kickoff. One back shotgun with a bunch formation of receivers to the near side. Four-man defense in front. Swing pass coming near side. And that is Barrett Fallon.
Fallon on a carry.
He's their running back. He swings out, gets a relatively short gain. Joey Barrett Fallon, though, 375 yards rushing already on the season and averaging over 8 yards a carry.
Yeah, you'll appreciate a running back that can get you that many yards. Gets you put in manageable situations, especially on second downs.
Second and 10, no gain on first down. Hitch pass is complete, but the receivers hit immediately. That's Emmett Griman on the reception. But watch those DBs, Joey, come flying up, led by the strong safety, Reese Madigan.
Yeah, Madigan, and you're going to watch this entire Piper defense. They quickly combine in on any receiver or any running back. Everybody comes in to make those tackles as a team, not individually.
Gain of 3. Third and 7. The left-hander has plenty of time, still searching. Floats to the far side, eludes one rusher, throws it to the far side, and his pass is incomplete, intended for Griman, but excellent coverage by that Warrior secondary and the linebackers as well, and it's a quick 3-and-out for the Wolves.
That's exactly what Piper wanted to come into today's game, especially with the way the second half got out of hand last week at Piper, so a good start to the ball game, forcing the 3-and-out.
Miles Mendez, the left footer, is the punter, gets it away, it's a good one, turns over, drives the return man deep, makes a fair catch. And on the fair catch is Jackson Hopper. And now we'll get a look at a Piper offense that just absolutely lit it up in their first game against Leander Glenn, and then really had a rough time last week in that loss to Wimberley. No shame there. Wimberley went all the way to the 4A state championship game a year ago.
Yeah, and Paul, if you remember last week, there were plenty of opportunities for this team to get on the board. It was just mental errors. Hopefully they clean those up here in week 3.
On first down, 4 wides, 2 to either side. South, the quarterback, throws the slant. It's complete to Nolan Doss, and that's a good sign. Remember, Doss caught 4 touchdown passes in the opener, but then got shut out last week. They need to get him going.
Yeah, Nolan Doss was a little quiet last week, but, I mean, he gets open right there and picks up the first down for Piper.
Although, appears we have a penalty on the play. I think it's illegal receiver downfield, so that will negate that first down.
Well, this is one thing that we're going to have to watch for tonight is Piper. They got to find a way to eliminate the penalties. Paul, in week number 1, there really weren't too many penalties against Glenn.
5-yard penalty, remain first down.
Well, they lament that one because that was a good, solid play. And it was negated by that ineligible receiver downfield penalty, moving the ball back to the 25-yard line.
First and 15, Warriors.
They'll stay with the 4 wides, 2 to either side. The outside receiver to the near side is Jake Strachan, one of their two quarterbacks, but he's also an outstanding receiver. So when Jake South is playing quarterback, Jake Strachan is on the field as a wideout. South, under pressure, comes to the far side, tries to tuck it up and move forward, but it's officially a sack as he is brought down by outside linebacker Tate Broadus.
Paul, going back to that mention of Jake Strachan, remember last week he was kind of the receiver that was making plays happen. He was bracing the contact and really making those difficult grabs whenever he was targeted.
Lost about a yard and a half, so it is officially a sack. Running play. That's John Hamilton on the carry. And he plows forward for a couple of yards, but the Warriors are going to be looking at third and 12. Clock moving with 9:30 remaining here in this opening period.
Piper will try to get that running game going a little bit more this week. Brady Hopper was kind of the guy who was getting those majority of the touches last week.
Third down play. Wolves bring a blitz. It's picked up. South goes to the far side, now pulls the trigger down the far sideline. Receiver DB get tangled up a little bit, but there's no flag. It's incomplete. And with that, the Warriors are, one would assume, going to have to punt the football away. And that is the case.
Yeah, looks like Mason Kruger was the intended target there. I'm not sure if he kind of lost the ball there. A little overthrown by Jake South, so three and outs for both of these defenses to start the game.
Number one, Emmett Griman, on the punt for Piper. Seven, Jake Strachan.
Strachan will punt. Griman is the deep return man. That ball was almost blocked, but he gets it away. It takes a Warrior roll inside the 25, down around the 22, down to the 21 before it's killed, so it winds up being an effective punt.
Yeah, Paul, that was a Warrior roll plus some. I mean, that ball just kept on rolling an extra 10 yards off the bounce, and pretty good positioning there for the Piper defense.
Wound up being a 51-yard punt.
For Robert Juarez.
So the Wolves will start this drive from their 21-yard line.
Robert Juarez.
Tristan Hamlin, the quarterback. Had an up-and-down night a week ago against Kerrville Tyvee. He threw a touchdown pass, but also threw two picks. Two receivers to the near side for Davenport. Play fake. Ball thrown over the middle to Griman. That's their outstanding tight end. Gets it across the 40-yard line to the 41 for a first down. And I will tell you this, Joey, it's not many teams that have a tight end who can get that far downfield that effectively.
Really unmarked there, wide 15-yard gain there, and the senior making a play happen. First down for Davenport.
From the 41, three-man defensive front this time for the Warriors. One back gun. Hamlin wants to throw. Comes near side, and there is a flag. Yeah, the defensive back may have turned him just a little bit. It was intended for Griman, and there was some contact. So let's get the call officially from the referee, Ron Tachi. And so the Wolves, don't get me wrong, the penalty was legitimate, but they catch a break because really that play wasn't going anywhere. But
yeah,
they wind up with the walk-off.
And that pass is probably 2 yards behind the line of scrimmage. But one thing that Piper's going to have to watch out for, Griman, probably one of the bigger guys on this Davenport team. The Warriors are going to have to quickly combine in whenever he gets a touch on the ball.
Now they're moving the ball back the other direction. And if you have a clue of what's going on here, you're ahead of me. But when it all shakes out, the line of scrimmage is the 43-yard line, and we have a whistle, and this may require some more sorting out. All right, now they're going to wind the clock. From the Wolf, 43. Hamlin keeps, takes a big hit after about a 1 yard gain, so it'll be second and nine as we move under 8 minutes remaining here in the first quarter.
Great pursuit there by the defense, not allowing Hamlin to get away. But on the other hand, Hamlin doing a good job keeping his feet moving, gaining an extra 2 yards.
Line of scrimmage, the 45. So it's second and eight. Again, three-man defense in front. They lay it off on the far sideline to Barrett Fallon, the running back, also an effective receiver. But once again, a pretty good diagnostic job by that Warrior defense, setting up a third and six.
I will say this, the Davenport team fairly balanced entering today, 462 rushing yards. Meanwhile, on the receiving end, 550 yards, so just a 100-yard difference between rushing and passing.
Two receivers to the near side. Corners start to crowd them. Hamlin keeping all the way, trying to get the first down, makes a limp leg move, gets past the stick, and skips out of bounds for the first down in Warrior territory, down around the 45, 46-yard line.
QB draw from the start. As soon as the snap was made, rolling out to the left side, it was Hamlin, and he knew he had the separation and picked up the first down for the Wolves.
Again, two receivers to the near side, but a two-back gun in the backfield. Hamlin has time. Deep ball coming near side. And we're going to have a flag. The coverage was applied by Jax LeGrand, and the intended receiver looks like it was Kyler Payne. They did get tangled up. Let's see which direction this violation goes.
Well, Paul, there were two flags on the play. There was a flag for the most likely PI down the field, and then there was a flag near the 35-yard line. So two flags on the play. We'll see how they go.
So already the referee, Ron Tachi, has been a busy man.
Penalties against the Warriors. Defensive holding declined. Pass interference against the Warriors is accepted. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Okay, maybe you heard the stadium PA announcer. Yeah, holding penalty declined. But the defensive pass interference penalty, of course, is accepted, and that moves the ball all the way down to the Warrior 31-yard line.
Defensive flags already costing this team early. We didn't see much of that in the first game. They got to clean that up going into these future games.
Hamlin, the quarterback, gives it off to Barrett Fallon, who comes into this game with 375 yards rushing and a pair of TDs.
Fallon on a carry, met by three, Vivian, 48.
Gets two on that first down carry, and it's second and eight. This time, three receivers to the near side, including that excellent tight end, Emmett Griman. Second and eight from the one-back gun. Play fake. Hamlin keeps it all the way. Gets a good game, but also takes a big whack at about the 25-yard line, and it's going to be third and about four. The middle linebacker, Caden Glass, came up to lay that wallop.
Hamlin not afraid to move the ball himself, but Caden Glass showing he's a dangerous guy in the midfield, and he gets a tackle right there.
Third and about five. Warriors showing blitz. Now for the moment, they back out of it and show a three-man defensive front. Two receivers to the near side, including Kyler Payne, the outside receiver to the right side of the formation. Blitz coming, they pick it up. Streak ball down the sideline, one-on-one fight for the football. It falls incomplete, and that's gonna set up a fourth down. It was intended for Dante Singletary, and that was excellent coverage by Jackson Hopper.
Yeah, Paul, great point. Jackson Hopper going up on that ball, getting elevated. I mean, that was a 50-50 ball, and if Hopper doesn't get a piece of that one, then that's probably 6 points for Davenport.
Well, they're kind of in the no man's land right now, so there's no reason not to go for it on fourth down, and that's exactly what Davenport will do. Hamlin, with time, sets his feet, lays it off on a crossing route. That's Griman, the tight end, inside the 20 to the 19, and he has the first. They convert on fourth down.
Griman's going to be a dangerous guy to watch all night long. He's got that speed. He's also got that size. Gets to the outside edge, picks up the first down, and Davenport in the red zone for the first time today.
This will be the ninth play of this drive that started back at the Davenport 21. Two-back shotgun. Play action pass. Griman takes it and then pays for it.
One, Griman, tackled by 15.
Outstanding defensive play.
Gain one, second down Davenport.
talk about an outstanding defensive play. Piper loading the shoulder right there and completely just stuffs the tight end on that play. Davenport only picking up a yard.
Second and nine. Three receivers, trips to the near side. Three-man defensive front. Running play. Ball carrier going to be brought down behind the line of scrimmage. That was Fallon on the carry, and an outstanding defensive play by the defensive end, Hiram McCarter, along with strong side linebacker, the Sam linebacker, Chase Keeney.
Paul, that's that combination tackling that we've talked about throughout this season, two guys combined, and there is absolutely nowhere to go for Davenport on that rush.
Third and full 10, under 5 minutes in quarter number one. Hamlin wants to throw, jacks it into the end zone. One-on-one situation. It's a fade route, and the ball just fades away from the intended receiver, Dante Singletary. Outstanding man coverage applied by the safety, Grant Oling.
A great 50-50 ball once again, and Hamlin proving that he wants to give those receivers those 50-50 balls. Go up for the play, and just a little bit wide, great coverage, and now Davenport trying to go for the 3 points and get their first lead of the night.
Yeah, they'll spot it down at the 27-yard line, making this a 37-yard field goal attempt for Miles Mendez, a left footer. Ball just inside the left hash, looking for the first points of the ball game. Got movement and contact.
A lot of movement down there in the trenches. A lot of guys getting eager to get that jump. See if it's a full start or an offside.
And it's important. That 5 yards would make a difference either way. Okay, they're going to say that the Warriors were offside, so that will make this a somewhat shorter field goal attempt. As they'll put it down on the 22, making it a 32-yard attempt.
Paul, that's crucial. If it would have been a false start, you kind of got to think, would Davenport have changed the play call on that?
Precisely the point. I agree. Mendez, the left footer, sends the ball on its way. And it's good. And we have the first points of the evening. 4:26 remaining in the first quarter. And Davenport now leads Piper by a score of 3-0. Back in just a moment. And we're back at Davenport High School Stadium in Garden Ridge. The Davenport Wolves get on the scoreboard first with a 27-yard field goal. Joey will detail the drive in just a moment, but first the kickoff, again by that same man, Miles Mendez. Mendez puts his left foot in it, and it's going to go out of bounds. Not exactly what he had planned. Joey, tell us about that scoring drive.
Well, Mendez, the guy who just kicked the ball out, put the foot on the ball and put it through the uprights to give Davenport 3-0 lead. 12 plays, 64 yards for 4 minutes and 32 seconds. And, Paul, a lot of time wasted off the clock there, and a good drive by Davenport and their first score since the first half of last game.
Well, keep in mind that the Warriors have had kind of a scoring drought also. They did not score in the second half last week, and have yet to score here with 4:26 remaining in the first quarter. This time they bring an empty set with three receivers to the near side. Jet sweep, it's a little shovel pass, and on the carry is John Hamilton, diagnosed very well by that Davenport Wolves defense. Officially no gain, second and 10.
Haven't really seen the jet sweep this season, trying to show Davenport a new look on that play. Doesn't work out in Hamilton's favor, but maybe a play that they try to throw in a little bit more.
Jake South, the quarterback, on second and 10. And we have a flag.
prior to the snap. Penalty against the Warriors for a false start. 5-yard penalty, replay second down.
Penalties have really been a bugaboo for the Warriors, really since the start of last week's game. 5-yard walk-off, second and 15. Motion across the formation. South has time. Throws near side. What a nice catch, and he's got it down. He got that foot down. That's Jake Strachan on the catch. That was done artfully.
Yeah, Paul, we talked about earlier Jake Strachan last week making those athletic, difficult plays, and he shows off right there. Goes up, keeps that one foot in bound on kind of a circus type of grab.
Really a one-hander, and a nice job of footwork, resulting in a gain of 6 that sets up a 3rd and 4. 3-man defensive front, but the Wolves are showing blitz. Here they come, right up the middle. Screen pass, near side, they had it set up. Strachan could not find the handle. And Joey, from the Warriors' standpoint, that's a shame because that play was developing very nicely.
I think that could have gone for a solid 10 yards. And on that play, Jake Strachan, before he catches the ball, he just kind of looks up. He's ready to turn his body, go down the field. And instead, when his head turns away, ball goes off the fingertips. Incomplete, and another 3-and-out here for this Piper offense.
Well, let's see if Strachan takes his frustration out on the football as he's the punter standing back at his 22-yard line. Emmett Griman, the return man for Davenport. And you would think the Wolves would wind up with pretty good field position out of this, but maybe not, because this is a fake punt, beautifully executed, and this is going to have a first down into Davenport territory at the 42. Were you watching the game last night in the NFL where the Lions did that and worked it to perfection? That was great.
Paul, you know that Coach Rogers loves to have those trick plays in there, and there's one of them right there. Gets a nice little snap and a solid pickup. And finally, for the first time today, Piper is inside of Davenport territory.
Gain of 25, and I think that was Samuel Campos on the carry. Two receivers to either side on first down. One back shotgun, blitz coming. Running play coming near side. Good job by Hamilton.
Trying to get Hamilton a little bit more involved as the season rolls on. Probably one of his better rushes of the night. Nice 6-yard pickup, and it makes it a real nice second and manageable.
Second and 4 from the 36. Warriors trying to get on the scoreboard. Two receivers to either side. South gives it off. Once again, that's John Hamilton, the junior running back.
One Hamilton brought down by Evans Williams.
He's about 2 yards shy of a first down.
Despite it being such a short rush, I really like that run from Hamilton. He kept his feet moving. He could have been stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Goes for those 2 yards after contact, and we're 3rd and short now.
He has excellent lower body strength. 3rd and 2. 3 receivers to the near side. Here's South. They flip it forward, kind of a shovel pass across the formation, and Hamilton is struggling for the first down. He's close. Let's see where they mark it.
One Hamilton.
There is a flag on the play, and it is noticeable that Hamilton's helmet did come off. Possible face mask call right here.
Let's check it out. Good call by Joey Gonzalez. Yeah. In the sense that he got the call right. Good eyes. Okay, so now penalties hurting both teams. I want to remind you that each team going into this game with a record of 1-1, they both won their openers in blowout fashion and then really had a hard time scoring points in game 2 last week.
Yeah, I was just going to say, prime opportunity right here. You've got the ball just inside the red zone right here. And Piper, when they were at Glenn, they capitalized beautifully on those opportunities.
Well, they got a first down inside the Davenport 20 here with 1:57 remaining in the first period. South under pressure, goes to the far side under big pressure, gets it away, and he's strong-armed, and he was able to get it in the vicinity of a receiver, so it didn't look like it was exclusively to avoid loss of yardage. So really a pretty good job there.
And I'd say it's good awareness there by Jake South. He realizes the pocket is collapsing. He's really got nobody to work with, so he rolls out to that right side, outside of the quarterback square, and throws it out of bounds and no penalty.
So after the incompletion, it's 2nd and 10 from the 19-yard line. 3 receivers to the near side, 1 back gun. Hamilton, the back, standing to the left of the quarterback, South. Throw over the middle, and it's airmailed over the top. It was incomplete.
Incomplete. Third and 10, Piper.
A little slant pass there. Jake South was going for just a 5-yard drop off, and instead he was hit as soon as the ball left his hands, and that's why the ball airmails into the Wolves end zone.
On your feet.
Davenport fans getting excited here, exhorting their defense to hold here on third and 10 from the 19. South, the quarterback, 3-step drop, throws over the middle. That's a slant. That's a touchdown. That's a slant, and that's a touchdown.
That was a dime of a pass. Jake South looks super comfortable in that pocket, drops back plenty of time, throws it right into the end zone for a touchdown. And Davenport with the first touchdown since week one.
Honesty is always the best policy. The Warriors do not have a number 19 listed on their roster, but it was number 19 who made his mark there. Matter of fact, he made six there. So it's a 6-3 ball game, and the Warriors are going for two. South keeps it, trying to turn the corner, now flips it forward. He has the completion to Strachan. If nobody went downfield, that's going to be a two-point conversion, and that will extend the Warrior lead to 8-3 with 1:38 remaining here in the first. We will be back in just a moment. Back at Davenport Stadium, where Piper has taken an 8-3 lead after a touchdown drive and a two-point conversion. We got a minute and a half left here in the first quarter, and set to kick it off is Logan Lopez. Look at this, onside attempt. Oh, beautifully executed. It doesn't get any better than that. It doesn't get any better than that. That was recovered so beautifully by Adrian Pike, but the execution by the kicker, Logan Lopez, absolutely textbook, and you know you're going to see that from Coach Rogers. It is his trademark.
I just got a smile on my face. I mean, I don't know how much better that could get. A perfectly chip shot. I would say that's like in golf. You're just outside of the green, a nice 30-yard chip right into the hole. I mean, that was perfectly went right into Pike's hands. And just like that, two trick plays, and they both worked for Coach Rogers.
Why don't you set that scoring drive for us as well?
8 plays, 70 yards, 2 minutes and 54 seconds, topped off by a 19-yard pass from the quarterback, Jake South, and then followed by a two-point conversion.
After that beautiful onside kick, the line of scrimmage, the 47-yard line at Davenport's end of the field. South wants to throw, brings it near side. There's that man, number 19 again.
Well, you mentioned he's not listed on the roster.
This is what I think is happening. The Warriors have a player who they really value. They think he's going to be a great player. There's been some dispute about his residence and eligibility. They were hoping they would get him back on the field. That may be him. That's pure speculation on my part. We'll try to confirm. Running play on second down, and that's Brady Hopper in the game at running back.
If you remember last week, Brady Hopper was our player of the week. Moved the ball forward, and just right there he gets stuffed, but still third and very short.
No gain on the play, third down.
Third, let's call it a short two as we approach the 1 minute mark here in period number one. Strachan, the wide receiver, is the farthest man out here on the near side. He's the outside of three receivers, one back gun. Three-man defensive front. South to Strachan, who makes a move. Oh, if he'd kept his feet, if he'd been able to, it would have been a huge gain. As it is, it's still a first down at the 35-yard line.
I like that awareness by Jake Strachan. He gets tripped up and he doesn't know exactly where the pylon is, so he extends the body forward, and he ends up picking up an extra 5 yards.
Very heady player. Two receivers to either side of the formation, but in this case, they're stacked receivers. First time we've seen that look. High snap, ball rolling around, and South has to fall on it back at his at the Wolves' 44-yard line. That's a big loss. It changes this series dramatically as the ball goes all the way back to the 44.
Paul, you mentioned kind of changes the mindset of this drive. If they would have picked up yardage, they could have gone for a second down run, and instead you got to think they go towards the pass, but that's going to be the end of the first quarter.
9-yard loss, so it's second and 19. And as Joey says, we've played one. After 12 minutes, our score, Piper 8, Davenport 3. Back with quarter number 2 in just a moment. On a field goal, then Piper responded with a touchdown drive and a two-point conversion, followed by a perfectly executed onside kick, and they've got the ball in Davenport territory at the 44, but it's second and 19 following that 9-yard loss. Screen pass once again to that man, number 19. We've got a flag on the ground, and the receiver's finally put on the ground as well, so we'll see what that is about.
Reception by 19, Champagne.
Okay.
Game, brought down by 20, Bourne.
Apparently, that is the player that we've been talking about. Young man's last name is Champagne, and he is a great football player. He's not been able to play the first two games because there was a question about his eligibility. There is no question about his talent.
No question about his talent. Has athleticism. You saw just right there on the reception. Lots of quick cuts. He's a guy who can move his feet very quickly, trying to escape defenders. He was able to shake off three guys, second and very long. How is quarterback Jake South going to manage this?
They got to get all the way down to the Davenport 25. Three-man defense in front. Three receivers to the near side. South is the quarterback. And we got a whistle here as well.
It looks like movement on the offensive line there. And this is going to go backwards once again.
Penalty against the Warriors. False start. 5-yard penalty. Remain second down.
Well, Piper's been moving straight backwards following that lovely, successful onside kick. Lovely for Piper, that is.
At this point, I kind of just think you just run the football, try to gain a couple yards. You got to find a way to get a little bit of a chunk back from the way this drive's been going.
Keep in mind, it's still just second down. Two receivers to either side. Would you believe another whistle?
Prior to the snap, delay a game against the Warriors. 5-yard penalty, replay second down.
At this point, it's just kind of a buildup of mental errors there. You just got the false start, now the delay of game, and you just got to find a way to get back on track.
The line of scrimmage is the Piper 38. They have to reach the Davenport 25, and it's still second down. South tries to set the screen. The ball is batted at the line of scrimmage.
South pass broken up by zero.
It falls to the ground. No INT there, but that was a wonderful defensive play by the linebacker, Gianni Evans-Williams.
Good job there by Evans-Williams. They're just kind of putting a hand in front of South's face. Make it difficult, make yourself wide, and force the incompletion on second down.
Well, it took us a long time to get to third down. That's for sure. And, Joey, I think you're right. I mean, I would look for something pretty conservative here. South pump fake. Throws far side. Champagne climbing the ladder. Did he come down with it? Yes, he did. Third spectacular reception.
Well, Paul, I mean, even though he's still got about 15 yards to a first down, Champagne is showing to be, he's going to be a very good receiver all year long.
That was a 23-yard gain, and look what this does. Now you're at a field position at which you can go for it now, even though it's fourth and 14.
On this ball, I mean, you just saw Champagne just climb the ladder. He went upstairs. Why not just give him another 50-50 ball?
South steps up under pressure, moving forward toward the line of scrimmage, and is brought down at the 40-yard line.
South on the carry, tackle for a loss by number 5.
That was an outstanding defensive play by one of this district's outstanding linebackers, Zaire Livingston, who is also a quarterback, for, a captain, I should say, for Davenport.
I mean, he was fired up as soon as he made that tackle, and it doesn't get any more technical than that. I mean, he wraps him up by the waist, throws him down, beautiful tackle, and forces the fourth down.
So the ball turned over on downs. Davenport with the football at the 40-yard line. Piper brings the blitz, and they make it count. What a nice play by Caden Glass.
Probably the two more outstanding players on both of the respective teams. There, Caden Glass gets to the edge, draws down Davenport for a loss of about 4 yards on that play.
Second and 14, 9.5 minutes remaining before halftime in a game that Piper leads by a score of 8-3. Three-man defensive front. Play coming far side. That's C.J. Tanner.
12 Fallon on a carry. Tripped up by number 2.
Check that. That's Baron Fallon on the carry. And we mentioned his gaudy rushing stats through the first 2 weeks of the season. He's been averaging over 8 yards a carry, but Piper's done a pretty good job on him so far here in the first half.
One thing that improves me about Fallon, coming in as a sophomore, I mean, and he's able to take the reins of this Davenport team.
Third and 14. All right, we had an official's timeout. Now they get it back together. Everybody regroups. And they mark the ball for play. Tristan Hamlin, the fine quarterback for Davenport, comes to the near side. Now gives it off. It's a misdirection play, running play. Going to get back to about the original line of scrimmage. That's Fallon on the carry. Knocked out of bounds by Reese Madigan.
Great job there by Madigan. And there was an initial stop by a linebacker, but great job by Madigan getting to that edge and just shoving the runner out of bounds and forces the fourth down. And pull this, especially the second quarter, the defense is like really good for the Warriors.
Very sharp indeed. So Miles Mendez comes in to punt for Davenport, standing back at his 22-yard line. And that's Jackson Hopper, deep receiving for Piper. Snap's a good one. And the punt is away. Fair catch called for and made at about the 27-yard line. And we'll keep it right here in a ball game that Piper leads by a score of 8-3 over Davenport.
Well, Paul, that 8 points, it was a kind of a relief that his Piper team got back on the scoreboard. He hadn't really found a way in the Wimberley game, but now you know that you can score points, and hopefully they get back to that game that they played out in Glenn.
And as you said, especially for the last two or three series, the Piper defense is really playing well right now.
Forcing the three and outs, and then Jake South, he's looked really comfortable in the pocket all night long. It's something that I was hoping to see enter today.
Here's South on first down. Gives it off, and coming to the near side is John Hamilton, makes one tackler miss, and then finishes the run at about the 40-yard line, and that's going to move the sticks.
Another thing I want to see from this offense entering today, John Hamilton, could he get back to his form against Leander? And he's done so today. He's looked really well carrying the ball.
First down from the 40. They throw it far side. It's complete. Receiver turns it straight up for a gain of about 8. Very nicely executed. Once again, that's Champaign. And right now the young man is down on the field, and he took a pretty big shot there.
Yeah, it took a lower body shot for Champaign. But there's that athleticism once again. As soon as he catches the ball, puts on the accelerators, and he goes for an extra 7 yards, it's going to set up about second and a yard after the injury.
Training staff is attending to Mr. Champaign, and we don't want to speculate this, so we'll take a brief break back in just a moment. On second and 11, we're back to play. Running play, and once again, that's John Hamilton. The injured player, Mr. Champaign, was helped off the field to the far side. If we can get an update on his condition, we'll let you know.
Hopefully he's all right, but John Hamilton right there trying to just stuff the ball through the middle. Third and really short right here. We'll see what Coach Rogers kind of decides to go with on the short play.
Third and just inches more. And there we go. There's Hamilton again. And you can see that good, tough running that in this case moves the sticks with 7 minutes remaining before halftime. And Piper trying to add to its 8-3 lead.
John Hamilton entering the day averaging 3.7 yards a rush, and he only needed one right there, and he's able to get the first down.
On first down, South throws over the middle. That is complete. First down and more. Racing down the sideline is Nolan Doss, who had that outstanding game in the opener against Glenn when he caught 4 touchdown passes.
I don't know what it is about Nolan Doss, but somehow he just always finds a way to get open. And whenever he gets open, he's able to go for way more yards after the reception. And right there gets the extra 10, 15 yards and just outside the red zone for the Warriors.
This is the 6th play of this drive. South, with time, searches the field, comes to the near side, still looking, eyes downfield, got a man open, probably wants that one back. Because that had a chance to be a 6-pointer. That was Aiden Rice, the intended receiver, who was coming along the back line there, and they just failed to make the connection.
Yeah, I'm sure Jake South had, maybe a second longer, probably would have made the connection there, but you got to credit the offensive line. They bought Jake South plenty of time on that last play.
Second and 10 following the incompletion. 6:34 left in the first half. This drive started back at the Piper 29. South sets up, throws into the end zone, got a man. That's that man, Doss, and that's called a touchdown. And that's his 5th touchdown reception of the season.
Welcome back, Nolan Doss. We talked about him a lot again. Leander Glenn, wide open in the end zone, goes down to a knee to make the grab. Beautiful reception and beautiful play.
Nice touch on that pass as well, and excellent protection afforded the quarterback, Jake South.
And Paul, you just cannot afford to let Jake South get comfortable, because whenever he does, he's going to make you pay, and he does right there.
Leading 14-3, the Warriors are going to go for 2 again. They bring a tight end this time to the near side, and now motion. So the formation heavy to the right. They throw it back to the left. Look at the design of that play. That is just gorgeous. Stratchin on the reception, and that extends the Piper lead to 16-3 with 6:26 remaining in quarter number 2. Back in a moment from Garden Ridge.
There was a penalty on the previous play.
Whenever you're ready.
Back at Davenport. Joey, set that scoring drive for us.
1 minute and 55 seconds. This team knows how to make quick plays. 7 plays, 71 yards, 24-yard touchdown pass to Nolan Doss to make it 16-3.
Miranda with the kickoff. Going to be fielded at the 3-yard line and returned coming to the near side. Return man turns the corner. He's got some big yardage. And that is their star running back Barrett Fallon on that excellent kickoff return that gives the Davenport Wolves excellent field position, down by 13 at 16-3 with 6:14 left in the half.
That's why we've seen these onside kicks, these little pooch kicks. It's because the kickoff struggle, the kickoff teams have struggled in the first two games, and right there Davenport shows it right there. They're inside of Warrior territory, inside the 45 to start off their drive.
From the 43, three-man defensive front. Hamlin, the quarterback, the left-hander throws, and that's a nice job of settling down in the zone by the receiver, Dante Singletary.
Dante Singletary, he knows he's going to get hit in the back, so he goes up, absorbs the contact, goes down, and lays down first down for the Wolves.
From the 28, running play, near side. That's DeAnthony Moore on the carry.
Tackled by 34.
And just an excellent job of flying up defensively by Caleb Gale, who's having a big first half from his linebacker position.
Three defenders come in, quickly shut down that outside corner, and just like that, second and 10.
No gain. Tight end and flanker to the near side. One back gun. Ball's on the ground. Hamlin tries to scoop it up, does, and now throws it, and we'll see if there's going to be a flag on this. They'll talk about it.
Pass ball is incomplete.
Did not appear to be a receiver in the area, and he was not outside the tackle box, so there'll be a conference on this, and there is at the 35-yard line. But they're going to say it's all cool. It'll just be an incomplete pass.
Well, Hamlin, whenever he was releasing the ball, kind of got wrapped up at the end of that play. That's why he was short-armed, but Paul really could have gone either way for that call.
But it goes incomplete, so it's third and 10. Two wideouts to the far side, tight end flanker to the near side. On third and 10, three-man defensive front. Hamlin wants to throw, does so, throws it into the flat to the near side and fails to make the connection with the intended receiver, running back Barrett Fallon.
Well, Fallon, it looked like he wasn't ready. He was still making his route, wasn't ready for the completion. Hamlin kind of rushes that one, and now fourth and long, and this is where the Piper defense, I think they bring the pressure on Hamlin on this play.
Let's see what they dial up here. Play clock at 18. Motion across the formation. Big blitz coming. Joey was right. Hamlin throws it. That's a circus catch. What a marvelous catch that was by Dante Singletary. You really can't fault anybody defensively there. That was just a beautiful throw and catch. First down.
Super athletic play there by Singletary. Goes up with one and just snags it out of the air. And, I mean, it doesn't matter if he was triple teamed. Singletary still would have made that grab.
First down at the 15-yard line. Hamlin throws it into the end zone. Attempted one-hand catch is no good. Intended for Kyler Payne.
Hey, Kyler Payne tried to make it back-to-back for Davenport. That one was a little bit wider. A difficult play, but great coverage there by the Warriors. And now it's going to be second and 10.
5:03 left in the half. Hope you'll stick around at halftime for the Ferris Orthodontics Halftime Show. Second and 10. Straight running play up the middle. Gets down to about the 10-yard line.
Fallon on the carry.
That's Fallon on the carry once again.
Tackled by Ford, David Huntsman.
Fallon just trying to make it third and manageable right here. And this is where Piper has to get tighter right here on at the 10-yard line.
Third and about six. Hamlin comes to the near side, puts his head down, and then takes a pretty good double blow here on the near sideline. That was a pretty good lick by Weston Sanford along with Halino Spina.
Nice double tackle here. Fourth down, they're going to go for it right here.
Fourth and about three. Hamlin to the near side, gets knocked down at the 9-yard line. So he didn't make it, and that's going to turn it over on downs.
Great pursuit there by Caleb Gale. It looked like Hamlin had the open lane to get there, but he just slows up, and using all of his body weight there was Gale gets on his back and brings him down at the 10-yard line.
So a huge play defensively for Piper, and for the moment this remains a 13-point ball game at 16-3.
Paul, Piper likes to play quickly. It'd be interesting to see if they kind of slow it down and drain this final 4:33 here in half number one.
Both teams with all three timeouts remaining. This drive will start from the 10-yard line, just shy of the 10-yard line. That's Dawson motion to the far side. South goes that way, pulls it down, makes one defender miss, and is going to slide down for a gain of only about a half yard.
No gain.
Yeah, a half yard if that. And right there, Jake South just trying to keep the ball in possession, especially when you're at the 10-yard line. You cannot afford a fumble at that part of the field.
Second and really a full 10. Stacked receivers to the near side. South throws it to the near side. That's Doss on the catch, wide receiver screen, and he's brought down at the line of scrimmage. So two plays, no yards. It's going to be third and 10.
For a second, I thought it was going to be some sort of like a trick play, maybe a flea flicker. I thought Nolan Doss would catch it and go for a pass, but really nowhere to go on that play. And Paul, as you mentioned, still two plays, no yards picked up.
They give him a half yard, so it's third and 9.5. South looking to the near side, throws deep over the middle of the field, leaping attempt at the 48-yard line.
Flag on the play.
And that's Mr. Champagne back in the ballgame, but we do have a flag on the play.
Looks like going to be most likely holding against his Piper offensive line.
Ineligible downfield, decline. So that'll set up the fourth down, and the Warriors are going to have to punt, and they're not going to have all that much room because the line of scrimmage is the 10.
We'll see how far back.
The punter standing about 4 yards deep in the end zone.
Yeah, I was just going to say, we'll see how far back Jake Stratchin goes. He really doesn't have a whole lot. He's right in the middle of the end zone, but he's going to need a massive punt to kind of pin back Davenport.
Good snap. And the punt is away. It's high, but relatively short. Fair catch called for and made at the 35-yard line. And Davenport is going to have good field position and still 3 minutes and 14 seconds with which to work before halftime.
All right there, Jake Strachan, instead of going for a low line drive kick, he just puts it up in the air, allows his special teams unit to get there in time. And now Davenport at the 35. We'll see if they can capitalize on prime field position right here.
Sun finally disappearing beneath the horizon, breaking the heart of exactly no one here. First down, three-man defensive front. Hamlin. Ball falls out of his hand. His hand may be sweaty. It fell out. He had to fall on the ball back at about the 44-yard line.
That's a huge loss right there. Nearly lost 10 yards. But Hamlin, you could see he had his eyes down the field. Who knows what type of ball that could have been. It probably could have been gone for a touchdown pass. But instead of going for a touchdown, they're back 10 yards, second and long.
20, in fact. Piper sends three. Ball thrown near sideline. It's incomplete. It was intended for Dante Singletary and defended by the star linebacker, star being a position in the system, Jackson Hopper.
The 213's getting a hand on that one. Jackson Hopper saw that ball kind of ricochet down, rolled off of his fingertips. Third and 20. We'll see if the pressure comes or if Piper plays a little bit more conservative here on this third and 20.
And if Piper gets the ball back, they're still going to have some time before intermission. Hamlin looks left, screens right, going to be 12 yards shy of first down yardage. And the clock rolls with 2:22. Left in the half.
It looked like Caden Glass is the one who made the tackle right there, and I really have no clue where Glass came from. He came sprinting, wrapped up the runner by the legs, and now about fourth and 13.
Caden Glass having an outstanding first half. 4th and 13. DBs galore in the game for Piper. Hamlin steps up. Tries a slant over the middle, and it's incomplete. That was intended for the tight end, Emmett Griman.
Emmett's pass intended for one.
But that'll flip it over on downs. And as we said, Piper still has just under 2 minutes remaining with which to work, and they have all three of their timeouts.
Yeah, a minute 50 with three timeouts. I mean, that's a solid 3 minutes almost, and you got the sidelines to work with as well. You're up by 13 points, and I think if Piper can find a way to score a touchdown or at least 3 points, it really will send a message to Davenport going into halftime.
And remember, Piper will get the ball to start the second half. South sets the screen far side. That's Strachan, and he's lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Pass complete to Strachan, brought down by 20, Cole Bourne. No gain, second down.
I will say that's Four offensive plays now for Piper, where the Davenport defense has not allowed a single yard.
Intended for Champagne here on second down. Incomplete.
Third and 10.
Big third down play here with the clock stop following the incompletion and 1:27 showing.
Coach Zimmerhansel for the Wolves, he's got to be pleased with the way his defense has performed here in the final 5 minutes of the second quarter for the Wolves.
On third and 10, they motion to empty. South wants to throw, sets his feet. Deep ball coming near side, looking. Well, the pass falls incomplete. He had a wide receiver there. That was Nathan Martinez, the fine senior wide receiver, who had a big night against Glenn. Really a circus catch against Glenn in week number one. Haven't heard much from him last week, but Martinez regarded as one of their absolute frontline receivers. And, Joey, he had a step.
Yeah, he sure did. If he would have caught it, he would have been in stride as well. But one thing I want to notice, Jake Strachan, he got leveled at the end of that throw, and he still slung that ball way down the field.
Here's the punt. And that's Strachan. He gets it away. And it's relatively short, going to be killed at about the Davenport 46-yard line.
Fourth ball, first and 10 from their own 46-yard line.
Not the farthest punt that you're going to see tonight, but especially with the way the Piper defense has been right now, 50-yard line really isn't the biggest concern for Coach Rogers' defense.
The drive following the punt starts at the Wolves' 46-yard line. They're down 13 at 16-3 late in the first half. Three-man defensive front. Gadget play. The running back, Fallon, throws it to a wide-open receiver inside the 20, heading for the goal line. at the 5, and into the end zone goes Emmett Griman. Emmett Griman, his 4th touchdown reception of the season. Perfectly executed halfback option pass.
Griman, what a cut to his left side. A defender right in front of him gets a nice little shimmy step, and into the end zone goes Davenport. What a play. What a response with less than a minute to go in half number one.
16-9 now, and here's the PAT by Mendez. The left footer sends the ball on his way, and he knocks it through. What an abrupt change of momentum. 56 seconds remaining before halftime. And with that, Davenport has closed the deficit to 16-10. And since there's so little time left here in the half, we'll keep it right here.
Well, all it took was one play, 54 yards, and to the house goes the Wolves. Griman showing his speed right there. And, Paul, I mean, we've seen some athletic plays tonight, but Griman, what a cut, makes a defender miss. And just like that, the Wolves are within 6. And if you're the Davenport, you got to be pleased going into halftime.
Well, look at the tempo in this game. Just a moment ago, we were saying, hey, look, it looks like Piper may have time to score before halftime. And then all of a sudden, it's Davenport that scores before halftime.
Well, I will say 56 seconds, 3 timeouts. The speed that this Piper offense plays at, it's not over till this half ends. I mean, with those 3 timeouts, who knows? And if you get a good return right here, what can quarterback Jake South do with the ball?
Coming up, the Ferris Orthodontics Halftime Show. And, yes, we'll be hearing from both bands, the Piper Band of Warriors under the direction of Evan Berry and the Davenport High School Band directed by Jeffrey Keyes. Mendez set to kick it off. Fair catch called for and made at the 22. So by rule, they bring it out to the 25.
Yeah, Mendez not going to allow Piper to turn that ball at all. You want to make sure that Piper has to go the furthest length as possible. And why not just put a little pooch kick on there and force Piper to have to go 75 yards if they want to score again.
All right, ball spotted at the 24. 3 receivers to the far side. Play fake. Slant pass over the middle. And that's on the reception, Nolan Doss.
On the reception, brought down by 17, Singletary. Second down.
South, the quarterback, gives it off. Running play coming near side.
Hamilton on the carry.
That's John Hamilton on the carry.
By 11.
Clock running with now under 30 seconds remaining in the half. 3rd and 3.
A Piper, no urgency right now to get off a snap right now. Probably go one last play. If not, you can just run out the clock. And Paul, as you mentioned, they get the ball to start off the second half anyways.
So at halftime, we have 2 such outstanding high school bands. We're just going to let them play. And we have now reached halftime, and our score after 24 minutes, Piper leads Davenport 16-10. Back in just a moment with the Ferris Orthodontics Halftime Show.
Oh man, here's a broken play. I don't think any of these guys are north to south runners. I mean, look at this one here. Just bounced outside with no blockers ahead of him. But you know, you can always call a Hail Mary, and the guy that you want as your QB is Dr. Ferris. I mean, you give Dr. Ferris the ball, and boom, good things happen. Yep, that's Ferris Orthodontics again with that really nice new smile.
Get a shake with your points and some fries on the side with your points.
You get more with every order.
Woo! Get a Whataburger or a patty melt or some breakfast with the points.
You get more with every order.
Get a biscuit or a brownie, but no matter what you pick, you get more.
Like your favorite Whataburger or whatever, cause it all gives you more with Whataburger rewards.
Fun part of being a dad, but I have to speak to you about something that is concerning me.
Concerning you?
Yeah. Heard you and your mother talking about this Arlo fella, and
Arlo?
I wasn't eavesdropping. He's always watching you. His videos are secure. This guy sounds like a creep.
It's not.
Your privacy is very important to me, and I think you need to make better decisions when it comes to boys. And this Arlo is not a boy that I think you should be dating.
You're dating someone?
Yeah, Arlo. I heard you guys talking about him.
Arlo?
Yeah.
Dad, Arlo's the name of the new security cameras that we got from our service provider. We were talking about how great they are and how safe they make me feel. Arlo's not a boy.
Well, that's a boy's name.
Oh, boy.
Not a boy. Apparently, we just learned that it's a camera named after a boy. Why don't you name it Peter?
Of the week, Healy Vahati. Golden Heart of the week, Gracie Ibarra. Legends officers are Izzy Ledesma, Reagan Delgado, Presley Nations, and Grace Rayum. Legend of the week, Avery Kingdom.
Gentlemen, please give one more round of applause for our Piper High School Legacy Dance Team. We would also like to recognize our amazing Piper cheer. This week's cheerleader of the week is Addison Golsh. The Piper cheer team is under the direction of Emmy Herrick with assistance by Kelly Hogue. Joining us from San Antonio, Texas, please welcome the Piper High School Band of Warriors. The Band of Warriors 2023 show is entitled Checkmate and features the music of Edward Elgar, as well as selections by James Horner from A Beautiful Mind and Bicentennial Man. Inspired by the next chapter in the journey of our band, the show depicts the kings and queens of the chessboard engaged in battle. Please enjoy the depiction of the chess match as you look for the winner in the end. This Piper High School halftime is proud to welcome drum majors Jonathan Dooley, Arun De La Garza, Eleni Perez, Avery Tran, and the Piper High School Band of Warriors.
Thank you.
The Piper Band of Warriors is under the direction of Band Director Evan Berry and Assistant Directors Alan Connor and Scott Lowe. The Color Guard is under the direction of John Arroyo. Piper Ranch Middle School Directors are Dane Vereen, Kendall Tucker, and Lane Palmer. Band Section of the Week is the Color Guard. The Band Warriors are proud to be sponsored this year by our Warrior-level corporate sponsors, Trion Construction and Engineering, and Sidekick Operators. The band, Piper Band would also like to thank our most supportive administration for their assistance along the way for this school year. Let's go, Warriors!
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight is band night, and we are thrilled to have over 125 7th and 8th grade middle school band students from Danville Middle School. Join us on the field for halftime. We began 3 years ago with 33 performers. There are over 275 performers on the field tonight. We're going to start by presenting the Davenport High School fight song with our combined middle school and high school band. Next up, we're going to play Land of a Thousand Dances. Thank you. We want to give a big shout out to Kelsey Lean and Michelle Gonzalez, band directors at Danville Middle School, for making this possible. Thank you for joining us tonight, Danville Middle School band students. The Wolf Band was a UIL State Marching Band finalist in 2023, finishing seventh in the state of Texas. The Wolf Band is under the field direction of drum majors Eli Bliss, Kumar Carode, Hannah Phelps, and Josie Steele. Woodwind captain is Emma Cuencar. Brass captain is Alejandro Quintanilla. Percussion captain is Matthew Stanford. Front ensemble captain is Piper Haynes. Color guard captain is Morgan Lavage. This evening, the Wolf Band would like to perform the first three parts from their 2023 show entitled Up. Now presenting the Wolf Band 2023 show entitled Up. Thank you. like to thank our symphonic level sponsors, backed by Awesome Granny and PayFam. We also want to thank our concert level sponsors, GBT Foundation, Let's Get Pickled in Shop, Frank Dermatology, and Frank Landon Painting and Cleaning. Thank you for your generous support of the Wolf Band. Welcome the Warriors back to the field.
Partner Joey Gonzalez, and we've seen some swings in momentum. Davenport scored first on a field goal. Piper comes back with 16 unanswered, but then Davenport gets a touchdown right before halftime, and it's a 16-10 ball game, and this should be a really dead even Steven second half going in.
Yeah, definitely not a one-sided game at all. It's going to come down. It's going to take the last 24 minutes of this ball game to determine who wins this ball game. But Paul, good thing in favor of Piper, they get the ball to begin half number two.
After a very hot afternoon, it's turned into a beautiful evening. And Joey, I just realized this. You know, you can't always see how many people are in the stands beneath the booth. I just walked downstairs at halftime. We have a wonderful crowd here, almost capacity, and this stadium seats 6,000.
Yeah, I mean, it's filled on both sides of the field. Great to see everybody showing out here in week number three, and they are going to get a good second half of football.
And we want to thank both schools. They have been so cooperative and so friendly, both very class operations, and we're really proud to be doing this ball game. Here's the second half kickoff, and as Joey indicated, the Warriors get the ball first. They say that was a fair catch. Bennett King did run with the ball, but they're saying there was a fair catch signal, so we'll see if there's any violation here.
The only thing I could really think of right there at the end of the play, there was a pretty massive shove at the end of the play for Davenport. Players slid about 5 yards, but other than that, I couldn't really see anything violating.
Well, let's see what it is. We'll get the call from the referee, Ron Tachy. Okay, so they'll mark it at the 20, first and 10 for the Warriors, leading by six at 16-10 as we begin half number two. Three receivers to the far side. Jake South wants to throw, does. It sails over the head of the intended receiver, Nolan Doss. Little miscommunication between quarterback and receiver that time, Joey.
Yeah, to win this game, I just think there's that one play that's going to be a really explosive play in this ball game, and it's got to be you got to find either Champagne or Doss. I think those are going to be the two playmakers at the receiving position.
Two receivers to either side on second and 10, one back shotgun, three-man defensive front, running play coming far side. That's John Hamilton on the carry, and he cracks out across the 25 to about the 26-yard line where it will be third and four.
I think John Hamilton, he's got a good bounce-back game. He's been moving the ball forward, putting this Piper team in positions where they can pick up first downs.
On third down, South the quarterback. The running back, Hamilton, standing just to his right. South looks far side. Slant pass. Skips off the hands of the intended receiver, Jake Strachan. And with that,
broken up by
you would think that Piper's going to have to punt the football, although they have shown some trickeration tonight.
Yeah, I mean, we've already seen two trick plays tonight from this Piper team, but a three and out to begin the first half or second half, not a great start. And it kind of looked like Jake South wasn't on the same page with his receivers on this first drive.
Punter standing back at the 10-yard line. The return man is the electrifying Emmett Griman. Punt's going to hit and take a big, big Piper roll and will be killed down around the 35-yard line.
Probably the second Piper bounce we've seen go in favor of the Warriors today. We're going to start the drive around the 35-yard line. But the Piper defense, with the exception of that touchdown play right before the end of the first half, I would say they had a really good first half and especially a good second quarter.
So this Davenport drive begins at the 35. They trail Piper 16-10. Two receivers to the near side. Hamlin wants to throw, does, far side. Throws it up between two defenders. Pass falls incomplete. It was intended for Kyler Payne, Davenport's fine senior receiver.
Kind of threw up into double coverage there, Reese Madigan. If that ball would have been completed, he was coming in for the blow. Incomplete pass, second down and 10.
From the 35. This is for the tight end right up the middle. That is that man, Emmett Griman. And let me show you what they did on that. They set Griman up as a tight end to the left side with two wide receivers flanking him, and then Griman just went right up the seam. There was no question where that ball was going, Joey.
Yeah, I mean, he's a big guy, and he's an athletic guy too. He's able to make those cuts, and if you leave him open, it's going to be difficult to bring him down on a tackle one-on-one, and Griman just carving up the yardage on that play.
Kyler Payne is the man in motion. They flip it to him. It's a jet sweep pass. He's got some room to work, gets inside the 35-yard line, and is then driven backward at about the 33 by the strong safety, Reese Madigan.
That's a great job there by Madigan. He was all alone on defense, and he just wraps up the jet sweep and brings it down to for about a four-yard gain, but great awareness there by Madigan to use his strength and bring down the run.
Had it not been for that, that could have been a much bigger gain. I agree. Two-back gun this time on second and six. Three defensive linemen for the Warriors. Play fake, slant, over the middle, incomplete. It was intended for De'Anthony Moore.
Intended for Moore, incomplete.
Reese Madigan had a nice time there in the pocket. Really no pressure being applied by that Piper defense. Just couldn't find the completion there on the pass.
So third and six now. Clock stopped following the incompletion with 9:57 left in the third quarter. Two-back gun this time. Hamlin trying to set a screen, throws it near side. It's complete on the reception. I believe that's Barrett Fallon. And that is going to be enough to net the first down. The tackle made by Mike linebacker Caleb Gale.
That was another kind of juggle grab that we've seen in this ballgame. Fallon, the sophomore, showing poise. He's able to end up drawing that ball in and just enough yardage for the first down.
Running play on first down. Cutting back off left guard. And once again, that's Fallon.
Fallon tripped up by 37, Rodriguez.
Snap goes to the right side. Instead of going to Hamlin, it goes off to Fallon, and he's able to drive forward for a six-yard gain.
Second and four. Two receivers to either side. Running play again, coming back to the near side. And once again, that's Fallon.
Fallon on the carry, tackled by three, Vivian.
Just shy of a first down. It'll be third and one.
Officials timeout, injured player.
And we do have an injured player on the field. And while he's being tended to, we'll use this opportunity to take a brief timeout back in just a moment.
Third and one, Davenport.
Back to play on third and one. Running play, near side. Hard running, big hit. Ball carrier's down at about the 16-yard line. That's Fallon once again, and he took a big old pop from Caden Glass.
I think that's going to be a theme of the second half. Fallon continues to lower that shoulder on the run, and there's continued pops there, but a nice use of the body, first down for the Wolves, and they're inside the red zone once again.
From the 16, Wolves trailing by six at 16-10. Ball is readied for play. First down, again, up the middle, again, Fallon.
Fallon just continues to get fed the ball right now. Davenport realizing that he's able to pick up yards in chunks. Another four-yard pickup, and Davenport's going to continue to feed it to him.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Good job of coming up quickly that time by the Piper defensive front. But you're right, they're just force-feeding Fallon at this point.
Yeah, Fallon getting the ball once again, but Paul, as you just mentioned, quickly Piper comes in and collapses on Fallon, third and medium for the Wolves.
Third and four officially. Here we go. Hamlin, the left-hander, goes to the right side, knew exactly where he had to go, and he gets it out front of the stick. And that's going to give Davenport a first and goal.
Hamlin, not a designed run, but as soon as he took that snap, you could tell he had his eyes forward. He wanted to run the ball himself, and he takes it. And now the Wolves are just 5 yards away from possibly tying this game up.
First and goal. Running play. Down around the goal line. That was a tough run. And into the end zone goes that man, Barrett Fallon, his third TD of the season. That was some rugged running. And we've got a tie ball game, and now Davenport with the PAT is going to have an opportunity to take the lead. Miles Mendez trying to put the Wolves on top for now, and he does. Our score, with 7:36 remaining in the third, is now Davenport 17 and Piper 16. Back with the kickoff in just a moment. Please. We are back to play in Garden Ridge. Here's the Davenport kickoff. Relatively short, taken at the 17-yard line and returned to the near sideline. And the return man is brought down at about the 29-yard line. So this has been a back-and-forth ball game. And just moments ago, we saw Davenport retake the lead with a touchdown and a PAT. They're up by one at 17-16.
Well, Davenport taking back the lead for the first time since it was 3-0 back in the first. Barrett Fallon just marched the ball down the field. The sophomore ended the drive, 4-yard rush. It was 12 plays, 65 yards in 3 minutes and 35 seconds, capped off with a PAT. And just like that, the Wolves are up by one with 7:30 to go in the third quarter.
It's the 12 plays that I find most impressive about that drive. First and 10, South wants to throw, now under pressure. Throws it off to a man coming on a drag pattern underneath, and that's Isaiah Champain. And we have verified that is the story. Young man's name is Isaiah Champain. He is obviously a gifted athlete, There was a good faith dispute about his residence and whether he was eligible. Piper felt strongly that he was, and they brought their case, and the UIL apparently decided in their favor, and Isaiah Champagne is back on the football field. That's Brady Hopper on the carry, and he doesn't get much.
Davenport clearly has respected the athleticism of Isaiah Champagne. They went on the double on that last play, and then on this play, Brady Hopper unable to pick up really a yard or two on that play. Third and about seven coming up for Piper, and you got to think maybe that Piper throws in something new that Davenport hasn't seen in a little bit.
Two receivers to either side. Ball on the far hash. One back gun. Now they send the back in motion. Empty set. Three receivers to the right. South throws deep middle. Got a man streaking to the post. Did he come up with the ball? That's Doss, the intended receiver. And let's make that Doss the receiver. What a catch.
Nolan Doss, once again, a quiet week last week, but he comes in, makes a really difficult falling back catch. Huge first down for Piper, and they're in Davenport territory.
At the 35-yard line, quickly to the line of scrimmage. First down pass, falls incomplete. That was intended for Champagne.
Champagne starting to get a little bit more in targets, but Paul, Nolan Doss continues to be a really great receiver for this Warrior team.
The way he tracked that ball as he was falling, that was amazing.
And on top of that, I mean, there was two defenders quickly closing in on Doss, and he found a way to kind of find that pocket out of the air.
Super catch. Second and 10. Play fake. Throw. Far side. Ball falls incomplete. Just past the extended fingertips of that man, Isaiah Champagne.
Isaiah Champagne having to extend that ball just out of his reach, trying to make an athletic grab, but now third and 10, and you got to think this is fourth down territory for Coach Rogers.
It just crossed my mind, Joey, that this is the second straight game where first down has really been a problem for Piper.
I mean, it's just those second and third downs is where they're making it happen. But, Paul, as you mentioned, the first downs continue to be a struggle for both this week and last week.
Third and 10. Running play. Oh, man, and a well-called and conceived running play. And that's Brady Hopper right up the gut. And he converts that third and 10. First down, Piper, down and around the 17-yard line.
Paul, that's what I mentioned. They got to change things up. Davenport completely expecting a run play, go with a draw play right up the middle, 10-yard pickup and a first down for the Warriors.
Nice call by offensive coordinator Adam Arteaga. South, pump fake, throws into the end zone, streak, far side. Did he come down with it? We're awaiting the signal. Yes, indeed. And that is a Piper touchdown, and that's a Jake to Jake TD, Jake South to Jake Strachan.
Jake Strachan proves that whenever there's a difficult ball, he can haul it in, fading away towards the back line of the end zone. Jake Strachan drags the foot, comes up with a grab, touchdown Warriors, and just like that, we've changed leads once again for the fourth time in this game.
Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Currently 22-17. And we'll see what the Warriors elect to do here. It's kind of what I suspected. They're going to go for two. Quarterback lead keep all the way, but this is Strachan at quarterback. Did he get in? He does. And that's important because that is a two-point conversion that extends the lead to 24-17 with 5:23 remaining here in the third quarter. This is a good one. Back in just a moment.
Making a score now, Warriors 24, Wolves 17. In
a wild ball game and a good one, and this is fun. And this is almost as hot on the field in terms of action as the weather was today, 106 or 107 earlier in the afternoon. These teams are so well conditioned, though, and this has been a wonderful game. Every time you think one team has kind of really seized the momentum, the other one counterpunches. most recently by Piper, leads the game by 7 at 24-17. And that's kind of a middling kind of pooch kick where they're trying to get it into a dead spot in the return team. But Davenport is alert to it, has no problem retaining possession, and they'll start this drive from their 43-yard line.
Little pooch kick, but the Warriors take back the lead just before the break. 24-17 the score now. South to Scratchin was the completion. 8 plays, 70 people with 71 yards, 2 minutes and 7 seconds. And that is where we stand here with 5:23 to go in the third quarter.
And Scratchin was in at quarterback on the 2-point conversion, which he scored. Running play on first down. Who do you think? Barrett Fallon.
Not to mention now Piper 3 for 3 on those 2-point conversions. I mean, why not go for a fourth time if they do find a way to get back in the end zone?
No gain. I think my money would lean that direction. No gain. Second and 10. Ball squarely at the 40-yard line.
Hey, everybody,
get up in your window. Tight end, two receivers to the near side. They go that way. Throw it into coverage. Ball batted up in the air. It falls incomplete, but that's a really nice play defensively by Jackson Hopper.
Jackson Hopper, we continue to mention his name, especially on those jump ball opportunities. He thought he had it. The ball was juggling off his fingertips. Kind of lost his footing. The ball hits the green turf, but a chance for an interception right there for the Warriors.
Third and 10. Ball squarely between the hash marks at the 40-yard line. Davenport brings wide receiver Dante Singletary wide to the near side. Here's Hamlin, the left-hander, tries to get it to Kyle Payne. Pass falls incomplete.
Three and out forced by the Warrior defense. And, Paul, I got to say, that's probably one of the best defensive drives that we've seen from this Warrior defense all game long.
So now, obviously, Piper is thinking capitalize on that. They have counterpunched to assume a 7-point lead at 24-17. They'd love to add to that and would seem to be just about to start this drive with pretty good field position. The left footer, Mendez, gets it away. It's going to roll sideways, laterally, and be killed at about the 18-yard line. We do have a flag on the field.
17-yard line of the Warriors.
Nice punt there for Davenport. We'll see if this ball, where the ball moves. But, Paul, with 4:30 to go in the third quarter, this is another opportunity to get this back to a two-possession lead that it was earlier in the first half.
Yeah, they were up 16-13. But that didn't really seem to faze Davenport very much. Both these teams coming in with a record of 1-1. Next week, Piper will be at home to host Hallettsville, which will probably come in 3-0. They're 2-0 and playing an 0-2 team tonight. And Davenport will go to Lockhart.
Yeah, speaking of that game against Hallettsville, the final non-district game. So Coach Rogers trying to get this team ready for whenever that district campaign starts so they can have a good start and have a chance to make the playoffs for the first time in program history.
Two relatively new schools here, and both have done a marvelous job, both athletically and academically, and really spirited communities. As I said, we have a huge crowd in here tonight. You almost couldn't get another person in here with a shoehorn.
Yeah, I mean, everywhere you look, it's completely packed out, and it's great to see all the Piper fans coming in today. And, I mean, you look everywhere, you got the maroon, you got the gold, and then you got the purple and gold on the other end. It's the side. Really great showing here in Davenport today.
Penalty was against Piper, and it's going to move the ball back to about the 8.5-yard line. Line of scrimmage, officially the 9. Piper trying to add to a 7-point lead. Jake South throws far side looking for Isaiah Champagne. Can't come up with it.
Isaiah Champagne, the intended target on that play. Just a little bit too wide. The ball landed out of bounds. If Champagne probably had about I don't know, a foot to work with, probably could have hauled that ball in.
But once again, Piper looking at second and 10. That's happened a lot. South, running play, gives it off. Nothing doing, and I mean nothing. John Hamilton on the carry.
It looked like Hamilton ran to his own offensive lineman. Not sure if he got shoved into the lineman or just ran into him himself, and now they're playing behind the chains.
Lost a little more than a yard. Third and 11 plus. Pass is complete to Doss, who takes a big hit at the 9-yard line. 10 full yards shy of a first down. So the Warriors go three and out.
Well, it's going to be the second time today where Jake Stratch and he's going to be inside the end zone going for a punt. But important to mention, the Piper defense was probably one of their best drives, last defensive drive. So we'll see what the Piper defense can do after this punt.
There is a breeze blowing from the south. So Davenport has the advantage of that wind here in the third quarter. Here's the punt. It's going to roll outside the 45 to about the 48-yard line at the Piper end of the field. But that's still a really, really convenient place for Davenport to start this drive, trailing by 7 at 24-17 with a little more than 3 minutes left in the third quarter.
Several lead changes in this ball game, and Davenport, Paul, as he mentioned, prime opportunity to get on the scoreboard right here.
They'll start this from the Piper 48. Tight end and flanker to the near side. Three-man defensive front. Piper shows blitz. They come. They pick it up. Hamlin comes to the near side, skips out of bounds at about the 46-yard line for a gain of only a yard, maybe a yard and a half.
Piper brought the kitchen sink at Hamlin on that play, quickly rolled out of the pocket, saw that the pocket collapsed quickly, and great job there by Hamlin to at least find a way to not only get back to the line of scrimmage but pick up a yard on that play.
Second and 9 from the 47. Tight end flanker to the near side. Now they send the wide receiver Payne in motion. Hamlin keeps, finds a seam, gets into the secondary, limp legs one defender, and gets well into Piper territory at about the 30-yard line.
QB option there for Hamlin, and he goes back-to-back plays where he takes the ball himself, and he's showing that he's not afraid to use his legs to pick up the first downs.
From the 31, Hamlin, play fake, has time, throws deep, post route, complete, down inside the 10 and about the 6-yard line, and that's Kyler Payne. Make that 13 Singletary rather than 19 Kyler Payne.
Singletary going up for that ball. Once again, another play where he knows there's going to be contact, absorbs it, goes down inside the 10-yard line, and here's a chance for Davenport.
First and goal. This one gets inside the 5-yard line.
Fallon on the carry, brought down by 37, Rodriguez.
Fallon, the ball carrier. Clock running with 2:22 showing here in the third.
Hector Rodriguez, a solo tackle on that play, wraps up by the ankles and gets a stop.
Two back gun this time. Hamlin, zone, read, keep, sprinting for the pylon, gets into the end zone. Well executed play.
Great job there by Hamlin. It was a real difficult play for Piper. There was a receiver in the end zone, and Hamlin, who's just jogging in, takes it himself, and the Wolves have a chance to once again get back in front.
24-23 at this point, so let's see what they do. Right now they want to tie the football game because they have the kicker, Miles Mendez, on. This to tie it up. Kick is on its way. And guess what? We're starting from scratch all over again. This is totally dead even at 24. 2:05 remaining in the third of a really good Texas high school football game. We're back in just a moment. We'll be right back. Friday night barn burner, if I can date myself by using that term. It's dead even at 24 in this non-district game between Piper and Davenport. We are late in the third, and the Piper Warriors are about to get the football. Kick taken at the 18-yard line. Return on the near side, out across the 30, out across the 35. Ball's on the ground, and there's a big scramble for it.
22 on the carry.
That was Bennett King on the return.
On the play.
But the key now is who has the football. Davenport thinks they do. Their fans think they do. Their coaches think they do.
Davenport ball.
And you just heard the roar. They do. Alert play by that Davenport kick coverage team.
Wow. What a change of tide right there. Piper thought they were going to have a chance to go back down the field, and a fumble right in front of the Davenport sideline. And the Wolves are going to get the ball back after a five-play, 48-yard drive that lasted a minute and 8 seconds, capped off by Tristan Hamilton, four-yard touchdown run. And that's how we're tied at 24 with less than 2 minutes in the third quarter.
Thank you, Joey. And the Wolves get the ball right back. Fumble on the kickoff, line of scrimmage is the Piper 37-yard line. That's Payne in motion. It's a run-pass option. That was really a very nifty catch made by Payne, as he had to turn his body back against his momentum, and they get the completion, and they get about 5 yards out of it.
Paul, great point. Payne was still running his route. His back was turned when the ball was already out of Hamlin's hands. He turns back and finds a way to catch it at his belt buckle. Turns around and he's able to pick up 5 yards out of it.
A tight end and two receivers to the near side. Hamlin sets a screen back to the near side, and it falls incomplete. It was intended for DeAnthony Moore.
Moore got a hand on that one, but I don't know how much of a pickup that would have been. Piper came screaming out of the middle of the field, an incomplete pass, third and medium, and you got to think this is also going to be fourth down territory with the ball kind of being in no man's land for the Wolves.
You would think so. So with that in mind, that keeps a running play as an option here for the Wolves. Hamlin, the quarterback, takes the snap, has time, throws deep, far side, he's got a man open. Will he pull it in? No, it is just past the outstretched hands of the intended receiver, and you know that Hamlin wishes he had put a little more air under that one. It was intended for Kyler Payne, and Joey, he was wide open.
Wide open there, I mean, 10 yards of separation there. And Tristan Hamlin, I mean, he threw a perfect spiral. But, Paul, as you mentioned, if he just got a little bit more underneath that one, that would have gone for 6 points for the Wolves.
It would have. Fourth and five. And as Joey indicated, this is a situation where really it makes more sense to go for it on fourth down here than anything else. Hamlin rolls left, throws back. That could have been a long pick six. That was a wonderful diagnosis by Hector Rodriguez. And had he corralled that one, he would have taken that 60-plus up the far sideline.
Really iffy play. The Davenport fans a little frustrated there. It looked like there was a little bit of early contact. That could have been PI, and it could have gone for a first down. And instead, the refs let him play on, and it's going to be a turnover on downs. And Piper gets the ball back with a minute 12 to go.
I can't answer this question numerically, so maybe I shouldn't ask it. But how many times have we seen turnovers on downs tonight?
I mean, it just shows that both coaches are ready to risk it all. They want to go four downs, and they're going to use them all every single drive that they have.
From their 32, Piper, South, the quarterback, throws over the middle, deflected, and falls incomplete. And this Davenport secondary has done a pretty good job. In fact, both secondaries have been good tonight.
Yeah, they really have. I mean, no home run balls for either one of these teams. And you could tell Davenport's putting a heavy focus on Isaiah Champagne, not letting that guy get open. In fact, they're double-teaming him on a lot of his routes.
He was the intended receiver on that incomplete pass. Two receivers to either side on second down. They throw it near side, And the intended receiver, Nolan Doss, thought he had it, and it just got away from him.
That's a ball you got to grab if you're Nolan Doss, but on that play, kind of looked like Jake South was a little too quick to throw that pass out. It's dropped by Doss, and now third and 10 coming up for Piper.
And once again, first down has been an issue for Piper, and in this case, second down too. It's third and 10. South. Looking to the near side, now throws, and that is a beautiful, beautiful defensive play. Oh, there's a flag on the play. Oh, man. I wish I could take another look at that one, but that looked like a wonderful play by the cornerback, Jalen Morrow.
Well, pass interference. Morrow was just a tad bit too early on that play, a little bit too much contact in the back, and as a result, a first down. And, I mean, you can tell these corners and their safeties are trying to get to the ball as quick as possible. And just that time, Davenport a little too early on that pass.
You know, I'm not sure because I think he reached around with his offhand. We'll just have a friendly discussion about that. I thought that was a pretty good play by a DB.
If one of those plays could have gone 50-50, and instead, Piper getting the first down, and they need to find a way to capitalize on that PI.
Shovel pass completion to the running back, Brady Hopper.
32. Brady Hopper on the carry, brought down by zero, Evans Williams. Gain of five, second down.
Gain of five and into Davenport territory at the 48-yard line in the final half minute of the third quarter of this truly, truly solid ball game. Running play, near side. That's Hopper again, down inside the 45, still fighting for yardage, and they get him on the ground at about the 43.
Brady Hopper.
On what may or may not be the final play of the third quarter. And it appears that it will be. Nobody's in a real big hurry here. We've played three, and we have settled absolutely nothing. 24-24 after 36 minutes. Back with the fourth in just a moment.
Third quarter here at Davenport Stadium. Wolves 24, Warriors 24.
Fourth here in Garden Ridge at Davenport Stadium. 24-24 between Piper and Davenport heading into the fourth quarter, which begins with a flag and a whistle and a procedure penalty against Piper.
That's a huge penalty right there. I was going to say this is two down territory. I still think it is, but I mean, now that drops you back 5 yards and Piper just a little too eager to get that playoff, and now they're going to have to go from third and really short to third and medium.
Penalties have been an issue tonight for Piper. Ball still, though, in Davenport territory at the 49, where it's third and six. Stratchett in at quarterback, running play all the way, and he actually loses 2 yards back into Piper territory at the 49.
Back-to-back QB draws. That third down that was called for a false start was a Jake Stratchett designed to run. Right there, they go with the exact same play and end up losing a yard. Probably because Davenport was ready for that play. And now fourth and eight, and it looks like they're going to go to their punting unit.
Well, because losing 2 yards on that play took the idea of going for it on fourth down completely out of play.
Deep for the Wolves, Juan Griman.
But it doesn't take the fake punt out of play. Although they have that one snuffed out too, completely. What a good job of recognition by Davenport. The ball once again goes over on downs, and Davenport will take over in Piper territory here in the opening minute of the fourth quarter.
I don't blame Coach Rogers for going it on that play. They used it earlier and it worked perfectly, but right there are not able to go in their favor, and Davenport starting this drive exactly where they started their last drive, where they tied the ball game up.
From the Piper 48. Hamlin has gone all the way at quarterback for the Wolves. Tight end, the two receivers to the near side. Hamlin goes the other way, now throws it to that tight end. That's Emmett Griman. Nicely designed play, gets about 11 yards, I think, and will move the chains.
You got to keep an eye on Hamlin right there. I mean, he rolls out to his left side, finds his tight end, and they need to find a way to double right there, because if not, Davenport's going to continue to move the ball down the field.
First down from the 37. Gadget play? No, it was a halfback option. Well, he opts to keep the ball, he being Barrett Fallon. And there is a flag on the play.
Yeah, a really late flag there. The tackle had already been made. Maybe could be a holding. That's the only call I could really think of that play came to a conclusion.
We'll let them sort it out. This crew under the direction of the referee, Ron Tachi. Pretty lengthy conference here.
Yeah, Paul, this conversation continues to roll on here. 24-24, maybe this gives Piper kind of a chance to regain their breath right here.
Well, they're walking them back. And they're walking them back a long way.
Penalty against the Wolves, personal foul. 15-yard
it's a personal
penalty.
Foul penalty, and it moves the ball all the way back to the Piper 49.
That's a pretty big call right there, especially that Davenport had just picked up this first down from this exact territory, and now they're working in a first and very long. Paul, they got to make it all the way to the 27 to pick up a first.
Yeah. So it's first and 21 or 22. Ball on the near hash mark. Three defensive linemen with a hand on the ground. Motion across the formation. Hamlin, play fake, keeps it, cuts it back. Gets 2 yards and a bruise.
Hamlin on the carry.
Hamlin goes with the quarterback option there. Good decision there to hold on to the ball and picks up a couple extra yards that probably would have been stuffed at the line of scrimmage if Hamlin didn't decide to take the ball himself.
They still need 20 yards for a first. Payne, the man in motion for the Wolves. Hamlin, the left-hander, goes to his left side, pulls it down, going to get what he can, and gets out of bounds at about the 41 or 42-yard line in Piper territory. He was forced out of bounds by the linebacker, Caleb Gale.
Caleb Gale's had himself a pretty good game so far, and especially on plays near the sideline, he's able to use his body, shield off the offensive players towards the sideline, and prevent them from going for extra yardage.
Third and about 14. From the 42, the wide receiver to the near side is number 19, Kyler Payne. Tight end and two receivers to the right side of the formation. Hamlin with lots of time, throws deep, got a man wide open. It goes through the hands of the intended receiver, Kyler Payne. And the defense was applied by Adrian Pike. But once again, we've seen both of these teams have opportunities to get big plays and not quite be able to make the connection.
Yeah, I mean, that was a home run opportunity right there. I mean, a chance to get the ball in the end zone for the Wolves. And now they're going to bring out the punting unit And the last two drives, both for Piper and for Davenport, have been promising drives, and it have ended up going for a punt because of penalties.
Well, they got a real chance to pin Piper down here right now. The deep return man is Jackson Hopper.
Many of this punt goes out of bounds at the Warriors' 12-yard line.
Paul Piper got a really good bounce right there because Hopper called for the fair catch, and if that ball would have rolled back, Davenport could have gone back there and pinned that ball probably about the 1 or 2 yard line.
Yeah, as it is, they still are going to make Piper move the ball a long, long way as this drive is going to start from about the 11-yard line.
And, I mean, really, since Piper scored that 24th point, the offense has really been kind of static, unable to move the ball. Davenport's defense has done a really good job really tightening up and preventing the running game from going anywhere.
I really want to see what Piper does here on first down, because that has been an issue. Jake South, the quarterback, gives it off, running play near side. The ball carrier is number one, John Hamilton.
Yeah, Paul, as you mentioned, I mean, just trying to move the ball forward, but a two-yard pickup's not the most ideal play. You got second and eight now, and that forces you to likely go to a pass play to pick up a large chunk of yards.
That was a solid hit by linebacker Zahir Livingston. Gain of two, second and eight, one back gun. South looking to the far side, throws it on the corner route, and overthrows his intended receiver, Nolan Doss.
A little overthrown there. Need a little bit less oomph on that ball as Nolan Doss, I mean, if he had 5 yards extra to work with, he could have made that grab way over his head. And now, Paul, a third and very long deep in your own territory.
Third and eight. Huge play for both teams with the clock stop and 9:22 showing in the fourth. I won't say showing in the ball game because who knows, we may be here a while, which would be just fine. From the empty set, South wants to throw, now under heavy pressure, comes to the near side, takes a big hit, ball's on the ground, it's scooped up and into the end zone. Into the end zone goes the linebacker, Zahir Livingston. So Davenport scores points off the turnover.
Paul Zahir Livingston, that's his second crucial play of the ball game. He had a crucial fourth down stop earlier, and this time he goes for a scoop and score. Unexpected, that one was Jake South, scoops it up, Livingston walks it in, and for the third time today, Davenport has the lead.
And they really have kind of asserted their will here in the last few minutes. Ever since Piper last led by seven at 24-17. PAT is up and on its way.
Picture point is no good.
But it's no good. And the plot thickens. We do have a flag on the play. For right now, the score is 30-24 in favor of Davenport. Oh, my goodness. It's an offside against the Warriors. So that negates that, and we'll do it all over again.
It's hard to tell if maybe a Piper player got a finger on the ball, and maybe they were offside. They got a little too good of a jump. So, I mean, if it wasn't deflected, that's a missed opportunity for Piper to keep this a six-point game. But second chance here for Davenport to make it seven.
Miles Mendez, the kicker. Good snap, good hold. It's on its way. And there's no problem with this one.
That's the point is good.
So with that, the Wolves have assumed a seven-point lead at 31-24. 9:13 31. Remaining in
Warriors
the fourth.
24.
We'll be back with some good stuff in just a moment. Davenport Wolves have taken a seven-point lead at 31-24 on a scoop and score by their outstanding linebacker, Zahir Livingston.
31-24, and Paul, as we've mentioned all season long, this is a Piper offense who can score the ball quickly, and they need to show that right here because, I mean, there's still time to play with, but ideally you'd like to tie this ball game up.
Here's the kickoff. Going to be fielded and fair caught at the 25-yard line.
Kick fair caught by 26.
So let's see what both teams have at this point.
Warriors ball first and 10.
Because this ball game very much up for grabs. It has been a hotly contested game. There have been some brilliant plays. There have been some sloppy plays. There have been some missed opportunities. In short, it's had just about everything.
And I mean, we still got 9 minutes to play. Who knows what we're going to see right here. But, Paul, I like your description of the Davenport defense on the last drive, imposing their will. That's what they've done here in the second half.
From the 25 on first down, shovel pass to Brady Hopper, who's hit immediately and dropped at the line of scrimmage. And how many times tonight have we said it's second and 10 for Piper?
Piper just struggling to move the ball past the line of scrimmage on these first down. Ryan Howe coming in to force the collision with Hopper. And Paul, second and long once again.
Two receivers to either side. Play fake, pass, coming on the near sideline. The intended receiver is Strachan. He kind of got tangled up with the defensive back, Hayden Glode. But they say no harm, no foul. Incomplete, third and 10.
A lot of hand-holding on that play, but, I mean, the throw was about 15 yards too long. That's why there's no PI on that play. And another third and long for this Piper team who needs to get something going through the air right now.
South under immediate pressure. Throws the ball down the middle on the post pattern. That is Isaiah Champagne, and that is a big-time play by what is evidently a big-time player. Watch him run away from the defender, and what a throw by South, who was under tremendous duress.
It was just a matter of time before Isaiah Champagne made that impact play. Such an athletic guy. You can double him all you want, but eventually he's going to make you pay, and he did right there.
He did. First and 10 from the Davenport 35. Warriors trailing by 7. South throws off his back foot down the middle, looking for a receiver. Lots of traffic there. And the ball hits the green artificial turf. Champagne was there, but also Strachan was there. And I wonder if maybe those routes got a little too close to each other. Drew a lot of traffic.
Possibly a little bit. I mean, there was 5 guys down there, 2 red shirts, 3 yellow shirts down there, and Singletary ultimately was the guy who ended up taking that one away. Good stop there by Davenport on first and 10.
Second and 10 again. They motion to Trips here on the near side. Sal wants to set a screen back the other way, but look how disciplined that Davenport Wolves defense is. They had that completely diagnosed, and that's going to result in a loss of 2 or 3 yards. And the clock running with 7:48 showing.
I think the offensive line, they're starting to get fatigued. You can tell just Davenport continues to roll through that offensive line. And as a result, Jake Salve's having less time to think to make a pass.
Third and 12. Balance formation. Play clock at 13. South is going to be hit well back in the pocket. A delayed blitz and a really wonderful play as coming off the edge is Gianni Evans-Williams. And we've got a Warriors player down as well at the 40-yard line.
Davenport continues to use that blitz. They want to apply as much pressure as possible. And that time, Johnny Evans-Williams really unguarded there, and he gets to the quarterback really easily.
His second big play defensively of the evening. And we do have a Warriors player down at about the 40-yard line. We'll keep it right here. We have so much enjoyed representing both of these teams and both of these schools tonight. We have been charged with the task of selecting offensive and defensive players of the game for Piper. And That's brought to you by American Interiors. And we'll be announcing that toward the end of the game. But that really hasn't been determined yet because this ball game is still hanging in the balance with Davenport leading by 7 at 31-24.
Yeah, hard to determine who that player of the game is going to be because, Paul, as you mentioned, 7-12 to go. And honestly, just one of these teams are just one play away from you could be that player of the game, and a huge opportunity could be coming up here in these final ticks of the ball game as it looks like the injured Piper player is coming back up.
Colton Green is being assisted to the far sideline. Fine sophomore offensive lineman. And he's having a hard time putting weight on one of those feet. Let's hope he's okay. Our best wishes, of course.
Hope he's all right as well. Now Piper's going to come out of the huddle. Paul, it'd be really interesting to see if Coach Rogers decides to go for it here on fourth and what seems like forever right now. But, I mean, you're at the 45-yard line. If you punt, you pin Davenport deep. So interesting decision coming up right here.
I think this decision has been made. They're going for it. Three receivers to the near side. Now they motion to empty. South steps up, looking downfield, running away from a defender, throws across his body, and the pass is broken up at the 10-yard line. And that was a difficult throw, rolling to his left. A very difficult throw.
Rolling to his left, kind of on one foot. I mean, if he had his feet set, he could have slung that ball all the way to the end zone. And you kind of toss it up to the athletic Isaiah Champagne, but it just underthrown there. Davenport nearly picked it off. And now another fourth down stop. But, Paul, I got to say, it's nice to see that Coach Rogers, no matter what, he's not afraid to go for it on fourth downs.
That is for sure. And what an addition to this Warrior offense the wide receiver Isaiah Champagne has been tonight. First down play. Play action pass complete, or is it? Did it come out? It did. The ball rolled out. Intended receiver was
pass intended for six more.
De'Anthony Moore.
Yeah, De'Anthony Moore, the target on that ball, may have just bounced off the pads a little too hard. Ends up dropping that ball. Second and 10 coming up here for this Davenport team, where unlike Piper, it seems like they've moved the ball really well on first downs.
Very true. And if Davenport can get any kind of score here, they would be in the driver's seat. That's Hamlin under pressure and essentially throws it away on the far side.
Pass is incomplete, third and 10, Davenport.
Well, Hamlin went for the option on that ball, and as soon as he turned around, he saw two gold helmets coming flying at him and just kind of throws that one up towards out of bounds, towards the sidelines where Piper's housed. Third down and 10, and Piper needs to find a way to get a stop right here.
To say the least, third and 10 from the Davenport 45. Wolves leading by 7, 31-24. Hamlin with time lays it off to the near side. It's going to be a sprint to the sticks. The receiver goes out of bounds at the 48-yard line, and he's about 2 yards shy of a first down.
Brought down by zero, Madigan, 34.
That was Griman on the reception.
Griman is a guy you don't want one-on-one, but good job by Piper combining three defenders nearby, forcing him out of bounds, fourth and three coming up.
Going to bleed the play clock a little bit. Currently at 16. Want to make sure they got the right play. So the game clock is stopped at 6:36. Here's Hamlin on the keep, and he's going to be marked about a yard shy of the first down.
Hamlin on the carry.
You know, I really don't keep track of these things historically, so I really can't tell you, but I can't remember the last time I saw so many turnovers on downs.
I just think the game of football is changing.
Yeah.
You're starting to see, especially at the NFL level, more coaches are starting to go for on fourth down. And then anything that's done at the NFL or the college level, it's bound to just trickle down. And you're seeing here at the high school level, these teams are not afraid to go for it on these fourth downs.
Well, it's getting down time for this Piper offense. They trail by seven. South, a double reverse to Champagne. Watch him turn on the Jets. That Champagne's got some bubbles. All the way down inside the 20-yard line.
Wow, Isaiah Champagne on the double reverse. As soon as he broke that corner, there was nobody stopping him. I mean, he quickly got there, and as soon as he hit his stride, I mean, he was going, picks up an extra 20 yards, puts him in the red zone, and a chance for Piper to get on the board once again.
A 35-yard gain. They mark it at the 20. South throws, slant over the middle. It is incomplete. It was intended for Mason Kruger.
Paul, just talking about Champagne. Just think, this is his first game. He's already had two explosive plays in this fourth quarter. Can you imagine once he starts to get more in a groove with his offense?
It's, you know, it could be staggering, really, because as you said, he's had limited practice time. He actually had to leave the field with an injury briefly earlier tonight, came back from that, but he is a difference maker. Second and 10, South throws, middle, intended for Champagne. And he's got it. He's got his hands under the ball. He comes up with it.
Complete.
Gets it down to the 10-yard line.
Fourth quarter, it's been time for Champagne. Sticks his arms out there. He's heavily guarded. Makes the grab, third and short. And you got to think of a fourth down's coming up that Coach Rogers is going for right here.
They mark it at the 11. And as Joey indicated, it's third and one. Here's the snap. South throws far side. Complete touchdown. Defender gambled and missed, and that's Nolan Doss on the touchdown reception.
Nolan Doss, second touchdown reception of the day, and that ball is thrown right into the window. Nolan Doss makes the grab, jogs into the end zone, and it's now 31-30 with a chance to either go for 2 points or go for the PAT.
Right now, the personnel they have indicates they're going to try to tie the ball game. By the way, that was the sixth touchdown reception of the season for Nolan Doss.
Offer the extra point.
This would tie the ball game. Miranda gets it up, gets it on its way, and once again we are deadlocked. This time at 31, with 5:38 remaining in the fourth. Back with more of this just burningly good football game in just a moment. This one's still very much up for grabs in Garden Ridge. Piper, 31. Davenport, 31. 5:38 remaining in the fourth. Here's the kick by Logan Lopez. Ball gets into the end zone, so once it crosses that plane and is on the ground, it is a touchback at that point.
Nice kick there, forcing Davenport to not return it, but let's go through the last scoring drive. Four plays, 54 yards, and as usual, Piper likes to play fast, only 52 seconds, and it was ended up with a four-yard touchdown pass to Nolan Doss. Paul, now four lead changes in this ball game, two ties, and we're all knotted up at 31.
And this is interesting. You know, as successful as the Warriors have been on two-point conversions, you know, in the back of your mind, a lot of fans are thinking he's going to go for two and take the lead. At this point, I thought that was the right decision. You needed to tie the ball game here late in the fourth quarter. That's a first down run, and that's Barrett Fallon on the carry. Gain of five.
Remember the last scoring drive for the Wolves. It started off with Barrett Fallon, kept feeding him the ball. Is that going to be the method going into these final 5 minutes?
They kind of pitch it back to the ball carrier, Fallon. He's knocked out of bounds. Stops the clock with 5:13 showing.
And once again, it's Fallon. Back-to-back plays on this third and short. Don't be surprised if Fallon gets it for the third time.
Well, what do you know? First down out of about the 40-yard line.
Three plays, three rushes, and you got to think fatigue is going to be a factor going into these final 5 minutes, but the battle in the trenches, it's got to be won by the Warriors. If not, Davenport's going to continue to run the ball right down your throat.
Clock running with under 5 minutes remaining. First and 10 from the 40. Hamlin, the quarterback. Play fake. Throws near side. It's complete. And on the reception there is Adam Elza.
Tackle by zero.
And that clears for the first down into Piper territory at the 48-yard line.
That was a collision right there, but Elza absorbs the contact. First down and a beautiful job using the play action.
Hamlin, RPO. He passes. Hit his receiver in the hands, but it gets away from the intended receiver, Kyler Payne.
Well, Paul, back-to-back play actions, and I think that's a really good play call. You're so used to seeing Fallon run the football, go play action. It's going to open up your receivers to go far down the field.
So it's second and 10, ball in Warrior territory at the 48. Davenport would like to do two things, score, but bleed the clock in doing so. Running play off right tackle inside the 45 and down to about the 44 goes Griman. They use him as a wide receiver. They use him as a tight end, and they do occasionally use him as a running back.
It's got to be great having a guy like Griman, and when he could do it all, he's a Swiss Army knife of this offense.
On first down, they pitch it back. It's a gadget play. Halfback option pass up in the air. Flags all over the place here.
Balance pass intended for number one, Griman.
Griman, the intended receiver again. They like to use him in jump ball situations, very similar to the way that Piper uses Mr. Isaiah Champagne.
Paul, this is going to be an interesting call here. There was actually two flags on this play, probably both for the pushing, but there was pushing and shoving on both the offensive and the defensive side of the call. We'll see what we're going to get right here.
Well, they're walking south.
Penalties against the Warriors, pass interference.
And it is
penalty.
P.I.
Automatic first down.
And that moves it to the 29-yard line. 4:05 left in the fourth. A bunch formation of receivers to the near side. Blitz coming, wide receiver screen. It's complete, and that's a nice gain down to about the 22, and that's Kyler Payne on the reception.
Piper got a great job on the jump as soon as the ball was snapped, but a great job really quickly adjusting to the play. Hamlin gets the ball out quickly, second and about three coming up.
Two back gun this time. Hamlin keeps it, cuts it up. Inside the 20, down to the 19, ball may have briefly been on the ground. Davenport retains possession.
Third and short, expect an option right here. You got Hamlin, and you also got Barrett Fallon. These are two guys who could pick up first downs in their will.
If they get the snap right, they did. Ball rolling on the ground. The Warriors think they have it, and they do. And what a turn of events.
Fumble on the play, recovered by the Warriors.
Just couldn't make connections Warriors on the shotgun snap.
First
crushing disappointment for Davenport, but new life for Piper.
First turnover of the ball game for Davenport, and it couldn't have come at a more crucial time. 3:18 to go. You had third and short, and the Wolves end up pooching that snap, but now first down inside the 19, and if you're Coach Rogers, try to drain as much time off the clock as possible, go marching down the field.
Well, and they were in position to do just that. A Okay, here's the Warrior offense starting from their 18-yard line. Tie ball game, 31 all, empty set. South grips it, comes to the far side, throws it, incomplete, intended on the far side, I think for Nolan Doss. And once again, second and a full 10 for Piper.
It's been the constant theme of this ball game, but Paul, I got to say, with 3:12 to go, there's two players you got to look to right now. It's going to be Isaiah Champagne and Nolan Doss. Those are the two guys you got to target if Piper wants to find a way to pull off the W tonight.
Keep an eye on number 7, Strachan, too. South throws far side and just skips it in to his intended receiver, and it's 3rd and 10.
I think that's one of those plays where Jake South, he wants the ball thrown so perfectly that he overthinks it and just kind of short mails that ball and just bounces it in front of his intended target, 3rd down and long. And if you're Davenport, you got to be pleased. They just need one more stop to force a punt and get the ball back with under 3 to go.
Yeah, he was looking for Nathan Martinez, and the ball came up short. And Joey just told it like it is. If Davenport gets a stop here, they would be in a very advantageous position. South comes to the near side, throws. It is complete out at about the 32-yard line. And if it is, that's Jake Strachan on the catch. You know, he spent time as a starting quarterback. He's also an outstanding receiver. It was a great catch, but what a throw by the senior Jake South. That was a difficult toss.
Yeah, Paul, I mentioned the two players he needed to target, and there was Jake Strachan, the third guy that's important. Great job with his foot keeping him in bounds.
That's Hamilton on the first down carry. Gain of 4.
And that is what the Warriors need. They haven't gotten much going through the air, or on first down, excuse me, and right there they hand it off to the running back, and Hamilton runs it right up the middle, and finally, second and medium compared to first and second and 10, where we've seen so many times in this game.
Clock running, 2:36 left in the fourth. But who knows, four quarters may not be enough to determine this game. South, there is a flag on the play. Slant route, complete. And that is Nolan Martinez on the catch. Now we'll check the flag.
Martinez.
And we do have an injured player for Davenport.
Flag on the play.
Real quick on that flag, it may be a false start, maybe going backwards. As soon as the ball was snapped, that flag quickly flew into the air. And if so, Piper's going to be going backwards.
Yeah, Joe, you're right. The timing of that flag would indicate just what you said. Haven't been able to check the number of the injured Davenport player yet, and we will never speculate on that. Nice round of applause by fans of both teams. And at this point, we can confirm that the injured player is the cornerback, Jalen Morrow, who has played well tonight.
Yeah, glad to see Morrow getting back up, and nice sportsmanship from both sides.
Yes.
Seeing him go back off the field and hoping that he's able to get back into this game, because it's been a great one all night long.
And more to come. 2:16 remaining in the fourth.
Legal procedure against the offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Second and 11, back at the 32-yard line. And they wind the clock, and here we go. South, the quarterback, looks to the far side, pump fake. Now throws far side, streak route. And the pass falls incomplete. It was intended for Doss.
Warriors.
And it's 3rd and 11.
Jake South just impresses me with the strength that he has on one foot. I mean, he was rolling to his right side on his right foot. I mean, he slings that ball a solid 30 yards.
He can flick it, as they say. Isaiah Champagne in the ball game and is the middle receiver in that trip set to the far side. South pulls the trigger, incomplete.
Good job there by Jake South. The pocket collapsed completely around him and still finds a way to step into that ball. Throws it way down the field, basically like a punt to where nobody's around it. And now Piper incomplete. Looks like they're going to come out to punt.
Well, they have to. They have to. As much as they love going for it on fourth down, if you don't get that, you are handing them the ball game.
The only thing I'm thinking
is. This is not a fake. And it was a prudent decision because it's a really good kick. Rolls down at about the 15-yard line. And by the way, we're just having some fun here, Joey. I wasn't being argumentative. But that's fourth and 11. And at that point of the field, if you don't convert it, and you're unlikely to convert it, you're pretty well giving them the winning field goal.
It was really tough part of the field. But I'm just saying, the way that Coach Rogers has been aggressive all game long, it would not have surprised me if he would have gone. But Paul, as you say, very correct decision, because now Davenport has to march over 80 yards if they want to go for a touchdown right here.
85, in fact. They start this drive from their 15 with 1:43 showing. Hoo-wee, this is a good football game. Hamlin, curl route, near side, complete. Across the 30 to the 31.
Pass complete to number 9, Adam Elzer.
And that's Adam Elzer on the reception for the Wolves.
Nice little cut back there. Picks up the first down. And now Davenport, 1:30 to go.
Two back gun. Play fake. Hamlin throws. It's picked off. Oh, what a wonderful job that was. What an interception. And on that is the star linebacker, star being the position, Jackson Hopper. And he is really their big play bell cow defensively. Watch him step into the throwing lane, and I don't think Hamlin ever saw him.
I don't think so either. Jackson Hopper, he's been great all night long, comes out of nowhere, forces a second Davenport turnover of the ball game, and he picks up an extra 10 yards on the interception. And it puts a prime opportunity for the Piper offense.
Now, see, if you're Piper, that's how you pick up the fourth down. You punt the ball, you let it roll, and then you pick one off.
That's the way you capitalize on it right now. Jackson Hopper's been great defensively. And right here, you can't afford to go backwards. You've got to move the ball forward, whether that's on the ground or through the air.
35 yards away from pay dirt in a tie ball game. 31-31, 1:18 showing in the fourth. Stretching at quarterback. Throws it back to South. He's looking for somebody. Pulls the trigger, and it falls incomplete. Now, see, again, not being at all argumentative, just kind of reinforcing your point. Yes, Coach Rogers loves gadget plays, but you run gadget plays when you've got the field position to run them, and they do right now. So I like the call.
Yeah, right there, nice little creative play, but there was a flag at the end of the play.
5-yard penalty.
And Paul, as I mentioned right before the start of that drive, you cannot afford to have these flags this late in the ballgame.
They're still getting them. And it moves the ball back to the 40-yard line. Clock stopped with 1:10 showing. Strachan is the widest receiver to the near side. Now they motion to Trips into an empty set. That's Hopper, the motion man. South wants to throw, pulls the trigger, and throws it well out of bounds.
Falls incomplete.
Incompletion stops the clock at 1:03.
Tough play there, but a great job there by the Davenport defense, continuing to penetrate that offensive line, forcing Jake South to run out of time and just having to throw away the ball on that play.
Second and 15. Three receivers to the near side. South throws over the middle, incomplete.
Pass is
just a little low for the intended receiver, Isaiah Champagne.
Yeah, a little low and a little behind Isaiah Champagne. I think he wanted that one a little bit more in front of him so he could catch that ball in stride. And instead, he kind of had to slow down the ball behind his hip. And now third and long. And, Paul, you got to pick up at least 5 yards on this play.
Well, you're at a point now where you're probably thinking four downs anyway. Let's see.
Yeah, no doubt. That's why that 5 yards can be so crucial. Yeah. At least puts you within 10 yards, and at least a timeout's going to be called.
Okay, so Piper's going to take a timeout, but we're not because this is just too good. We'll keep it here. So Piper still really with a legitimate opportunity here. They have 59 seconds with which to work. And this has been such a wild ball game, such ebbs and flows. We've seen everything, including a defensive touchdown. You know, that scoop and score by Davenport. We've seen 3 2-point conversions. We've seen some really gutsy play calling. And we have seen a stadium that is just electric. We mentioned this. This facility here at Davenport is just filled up tonight, not just with bodies, but with enthusiasm. This place seats 6,000. I think 6,000 are here, and they're getting more than their money's worth. And we're happy to be bringing this one to you.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a lot of fun, Paul. As you mentioned, I think we've seen everything. We've seen special teams, the special teams force a fumble for Davenport. Everything that you want to see in a football game has been shown right here, and we're down to the final 60 ticks of this ball game.
Okay, Piper, Davenport, fans, us, let's finish this thing up strong. Third and 15. Here comes South to the near side. Throws it. Got a man wide open. That's his buddy Strachan. That's Jake to Jake. This is pretty close, but I think he's got it. Let's see where they spot it.
It looked like one line judge run ran for the first down, and they pushed it back a little bit, but it's going to be fourth in very short right here.
It is, and I will say this. I think that was a little bit of an uncharitable spot there. I think it was a little closer than that, but it's fourth and two.
Fourth and two. Offense is going to stay out there. Ball's at the 27.
Oh, my goodness, sure. In fact, if you convert this, you're kind of in control here.
Yeah.
And the Warriors will take another timeout.
On the field,
because you can't take them with you, and you want to make sure you get this right. You want the right play call. You want the right personnel package. And you want to remind everybody to stay inside themselves and not commit a silly infraction that could move you back. Because if Piper converts here, then really they control the clock.
I mean, you could do whatever you want at that point of the ball game. You could put it a little bit closer. You just kind of wait for it and kick the field goal. But you got to find a way to pick up the first down right here. And we're only 3 games into the season, and this is the biggest decision that Coach Rogers is going to make so far.
So far. That is absolutely true.
Paul using every last second before they're required to get out of that huddle. The whistle's already blown, and they're still in that huddle, making sure everybody's on the same page for this play.
What's that old saying? It's better to get it right than to get it quick.
Absolutely.
Fourth and two. Here we go. Strachan is the quarterback, and he'll keep it, and he'll get the first down, and he'll get down inside the 25-yard line to the 23.
First down.
And what I found impressive about that, they knew exactly what they wanted to do. They had that play polished up for that situation all week.
Yeah, they went for the QB draw, and Jake Strachan, he didn't even look fazed by it. He knew he was going to take the ball, leaps up into the air, and extends the body forward for the first down.
At the 24, 33 seconds left in the fourth. South throws, complete. Yeah, I'm thinking that's Nolan Doss on the far side. Clock is stopped with 26 seconds left.
And Nolan Doss caught that ball and then ran out toward the sideline where he dropped it at the end of the play. And it looked like when the ball was dropped, they signaled the ball was out of bounds. And now second and very medium.
There we go. Second and about three, 26 seconds left. Two receivers to either side. Ball on the far hash mark. running play, or actually a shovel pass, coming back to the near sideline, and that's Brady Hopper trying to advance the ball.
32 Hopper on the carry, brought down by 5.
14 seconds left, most likely going to let the time go down to about 3 seconds. Call timeout, bring out the field goal unit to win this ball game.
Yeah, but here's the deal. You need a few more yards, in my estimation. Ball's at the 15. That would be a 32-yard field goal. He can make it, certainly, but you want to get closer.
You want to get closer, but there's only 1 second left, so it's all or nothing now at this point.
There we go. So, that tells you they got confidence in that guy.
And I think that's so crucial. You could tell that everybody on that Piper bench, everybody has confidence in one another. They believe in themselves, and really that's what takes you far in a season, is that you standing next to the guy next to you and you believing in what they could do.
Excitement much? This game has not lacked for anything.
I think it's so exciting that everybody has just quieted down. You could feel the tension in the building right now. Everybody on the Piper side is standing up, and the Davenport fans are sitting down. But as soon as this play is getting ready, everybody is going to be standing on their feet.
All right, so the line of scrimmage is the 15. There's the 10 yards of the end zone and the 7 yards on the snap. So this is a 32-yard field goal attempt to win the game.
Field goal being attempted by number 81.
Daniel Miranda. The stage is yours, young man. And Davenport will take a timeout, as they say, to ice the kicker.
Now, there
a couple of different schools of thought here. There's the ice the kicker thing. I've always been of the opinion all you're doing is giving the kicker a chance to compose himself. When you first run out there, your heart's going pity-pat, pity-pat, pity-pat. The body will not stay nervous for longer than 30 seconds. Sometimes you can outsmart yourself. You're giving him a chance to calm himself down.
You know, I never knew the fact about that 30-second nervous thing, but I'm one for, prior to that comment you just made, I'm one for icing the kicker. But now that you mentioned that, pretty interesting comment right here. But as you said, the stage is set, and we're about to decide it right now.
Here we go. Stratchin is the holder. The kicker, Daniel Miranda. He either wins it or we keep playing. Kick is on its way. We're looking. It's good. Daniel Miranda comes through for Piper. He kicks the winning field goal on the last play. Jubilation on the far sideline. And the Davenport Wolves, who played so well, are just utterly crushed. But what a classic Texas high school football game.
Paul, over 5 lead changes in this ball game. It was a pleasure calling this game with you. But Daniel Miranda went for that kick. And if he was 15, 20 yards back, he still would have made that kick. That's how good of a kick it was. And Piper's going home 2-1.
Good hole by Strachan as well. What a football game. My goodness. First of all, we've been tasked to name the offensive and defensive Piper players of the game. This segment sponsored by Brad Hopper at American Interiors. Tonight's Warriors offensive player of the game is newcomer Isaiah Champagne, and the defensive player of the game is their fine Mike linebacker, Caden Glass. Players of the game brought to you by Brad Hopper at American Interiors. So what an amazing football game. Once again, our final score, Piper 34, Davenport 31. A week from tonight, Piper hosts Hallettsville, while Davenport will visit the Lockhart Lions. So until then, what a football game. I hope you've enjoyed it. We've loved bringing it to you. Along with my partner, Joey Gonzalez, and our wonderful spotter, Keith Schmitz, my name is Paul Alexander, wishing you good night from Davenport Stadium in Garden Ridge.
At Audi North Park, we believe that shopping for a car should be a positive experience. As the winner of both the Audi Magna Society Award and the J.D. Power Dealer of Excellence, Audi North Park strives for nothing but the best customer experience. From our receptionist to the service department, our team is committed to making you feel comfortable and respected. We know how difficult buying a car can be, which is why our brand specialists strive to inform and empower you to make the right choice. From the latest selection of new Audi models to our incredible variety of used cars, we have a model that will suit your lifestyle perfectly. Join the thousands of others who found the Audi of their dreams with the exceptional service at Audi North Park.
Hey, I got another one for you. And just look at the hole in this line. You could drive a truck right through there. I mean, the refrigerator William Perry could get a first down there. But you know who's going to get their number called for this one? Yeah, that's right, Dr. Ferris. He's like a ligating linebacker. Boom, just like that. And that's why Ferris Orthodontics is going to get the MVP for this one.
Tickets?
Yep, I got them right here. I'll see you at 9.
Call GVTC today for our premium Wi-Fi service. Because Wi-Fi dead zones are downright
terrifying.
GVTC, official Wi-Fi of the undead.
Fun part of being a dad, but I have to speak to you about something that is concerning me.
Concerning you?
Yeah. Heard you and your mother talking about this Arlo fella, and
Arlo?
I wasn't eavesdropping. He's always watching you. His videos are secure. This guy sounds like a creep.
It's not.
Your privacy is very important to me, and I think you need to make better decisions when it comes to boys. And this Arlo is not a boy that I think you should be dating.
You're dating someone?
Yeah, Arlo. I heard you guys talking about him.
Arlo?
Yeah.
Dad, Arlo's the name of the new security cameras that we got from our service provider. We were talking about how great they are and how safe they make me feel. Arlo's not a boy.
Well, that's a boy's name.
Oh, boy.
Ah, not a boy. Apparently, we just learned that. It's a camera. Named after a boy. Why don't you name it Peter?
Oh man, here's a broken play. I don't think any of these guys are north to south runners. I mean, look at this one here. Just bounced outside with no blockers ahead of him. But you know, you can always call a Hail Mary, and the guy that you want as your QB is Dr. Ferris. I mean, you give Dr. Ferris the ball, and boom, good things happen. Yep, that's Ferris Orthodontics again with that really nice new smile.
Get a shake with your points and some fries on the side with your points.
You get more with every order.
Woo! Get a Whataburger or a patty melt or some breakfast with the points.
You get more with every order.
Get a biscuit or a brownie, but no matter what you pick, you get more.
More. More.
Like
long as you want. With Whataburger Rewards.
Oh man, here's a broken play. I don't think any of these guys are north to south runners. I mean, look at this one here. Just bounced outside with no blockers ahead of him. But you know, you can always call a Hail Mary, and the guy that you want as your QB is Dr. Ferris. I mean, you give Dr. Ferris the ball, and boom, good things happen. Yep, that's Ferris Orthodontics again with that really nice new smile.
Into words. When I tried, life felt absurd. You left the roots of my soul. I tell myself not to lose control. I'll take it slow, but it's hard to do when you're a lion like me and a lion like you. You got the hands that I wanna hold. You left the room to the house of my soul.
Got the tickets?
Yep, I got them right here. I'll see you at 9.
Call GVTC today for our premium Wi-Fi service. Because Wi-Fi dead zones are downright
terrifying.
GVTC, official Wi-Fi of the undead.
Hold on to your horses because it's back. Unless you didn't know about it, in which case, it's here. The Jalapeño Cheddar Biscuit is back and here for a limited time at Whataburger. Just like you like it.
So, where are we eating?
With GVTC's blazing fast fiber speeds.
3.5 stars, not a chance we try anything under 4.
You might feel like other things in life are taking a little longer than before.
Ooh, what sounds better, La Fiesta or Dumpling Palace?
Ooh, Dumpling Palace.
Ew, gross.
We may not be able to speed up your dinner decisions, but we can provide fast and consistent premium Wi-Fi to search all the available options. Enjoy the GVTC difference, and please be patient with things that may have seemed to...
Wait, what are we gonna watch?
Slow down a bit. GVTC, connecting you.